boo, 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 boo. It's Lucky Day here with the 12 o'clock siren at Halloween on the Square. On my left is Dusty Bottoms.
Hey, everybody. How's it going on this fine, fair Texas Halloween evening? And on my my left, we've got little Neddy Nederlander.
Yep. What's up, fellas?
Little Neddy Nederlander.
You guys look great.
Yeah, you do too, man.
I feel like a schmuck.
No, it's good. Yeah. I like it.
Talking to the side of that mic.
Oh, yeah.
There
Sorry.
You go.
I forgot. I put on a uniform, and I don't know how to act.
We're
sure.
outside for the first time. Can you guys hear me?
Oh, man. The sun on my back right now is great.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like not bad out here.
Feels real good. For those who are listening, obviously afterwards, nobody's listening right now. We are at Halloween on the Square in Leonard, Texas, on the southeast corner again, right across the street from the studios, doing a podcast here for Halloween. There are tons of people walking around. Tons of people giving away candy.
How many do you think, if you had to guess?
I don't know. I think it must have been 30-plus, 35-plus businesses. So people, I would estimate right now how many.
I'm going to guess in my direct vision right now, I can see 300 people.
400 maybe? Yeah, I was going to say 400.
There's a little bear cub.
Bear cub. Brett Harvey, how you doing, DJB?
Bringing us a little monitor action.
He might have this monitor situation fixed.
Yeah.
See if you can give it a shot.
You mind?
It's already plugged in.
Yeah, sorry guys, we're kind of doing this on the fly here.
Yeah, it's all good. We're just getting started. There's a lot of people coming by. We've got a ninja coming up. We have got a couple that are dressed like a couple
that
walking
dude,
up.
That kid has nunchucks.
He does. In his belt.
Tucked in his belt.
Tucked in the belt.
I'll trade him straight up for this sombrero.
We're here with the Kikbax booth. My mom is dressed up as the Wicked Witch of the West.
I think
on her left is Caitlin Fuller, giving away some candy to a shark and a mermaid.
Yeah, we've definitely got a good. Hey, by the way, too, if y'all haven't seen Jason's nephew Grady, he is dressed as Prince.
Yeah,
Prince.
Yes, Prince.
That's a tough one to pull off.
Yeah, singer songwriter.
Yeah, just Prince. A lot of purple, really.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, and a Prince guitar.
A little symbol and all.
Yeah. I love it.
That's pretty cool.
Is it a custom guitar? Did they make it?
Yes, I believe it's homemade.
I guess homemade would be custom now, wouldn't it?
It would be. there's Brittany Hauser.
Brittany Hauser, how are you?
So, yeah, I mean, I think it's fair to call this the 12 o'clock siren Halloween special.
Fright
Fest,
spooktacular.
Maybe?
A few firsts going on.
Yeah.
We're outside
first,
for the first time.
First remote broadcast live. And in person on the Square.
Yeah.
First Halloween event up here.
We are.
It is.
We are in person. It's really us out here.
We expect to have some people stop by to say hi. And we'll have some interviews coming from different costumes and kids and hopefully families dress the part.
Well, that's the plan anyway.
Yeah.
We'll see.
We've been talking about the Halloween thing for a while.
We have.
It's finally here.
It is here.
What's our next thing?
We're looking at Thanksgiving time, right?
What are we going to do for Thanksgiving?
I think we've got a good idea.
Yeah.
What do we want to call it? We never discussed that.
I don't know.
I don't know if the term we've used is PC.
I don't care about
I'm not
about
really
that.
Sure.
Does, I don't care about it? That. I think we were
Can
starting
you not
with the Pilgrims and Indians party.
Yeah.
Pilgrims and Indians party. Is that cool?
Yeah. I'm not sure if it's PC or not, but.
I don't think anybody around here will get offended.
I like it.
We could say it's the Siren Shindig. I don't know.
That's probably better.
You know?
Yeah.
A gala of sorts.
Okay.
You know? But that sounds fancy.
Yeah.
So it's too fancy.
Too fancy.
Hit the fancy music.
No, I think that. I think
I was a little slow on that. Sorry.
That's
slow.
Okay. That's okay. We're outside, so.
Yeah. I think the idea behind it, though, right, is maybe going to use Matthew's building up there, the Siren Studios and the Kikbax headquarters, global headquarters.
That kid over there. To have a little event.
Pretty sure that kid is Buckethead.
Oh, it's Marshmallow.
Oh.
Marshmallow's a thing for kids.
Buckethead would have been
Garrett brought up wanting to be Marshmallow or a kid in his class was wanting to be Marshmallow. It's a DJ.
Hey, EDM guy.
If that kid got the other
crazy.
Kid's nunchucks, he could be Buckethead.
That's true. And Grady's guitar.
And Grady's guitar. Yeah. He could be Buckethead in no time.
It'd be great.
How we doing?
Things are starting to pick it up a little
people.
Bit.
Yeah.
Who's that guy?
We're kind of at the end here across from the cafe, the new cafe, Leonard Family Cafe. I can't even see the sticker from here. Leonard Family Restaurant and Cafe across from Knucklehead's little tent, not the building, but the tent. They've got their wrapped F-150 out front. We've got our wrapped K Kikbax Offroad Kikbax Creeper out front. We got the trailer here. Tons of candy come on by. Oh, what is this? What are you seeing?
Oh, it's
one of those blow up inflatable things,
the wind floppy things.
Yeah, with goofy eyeballs.
What do you call those?
Wind floppers.
Wind floppies.
Wind floppers.
Wind floppies.
I'm gonna go with that.
Buckethead.
I'm gonna post here.
Who's next to us? Is that the Beta Club? I believe it's Beta Club. Is to our left.
They are.
Across from Perimeter Electric is across from us. They got the blue tent.
Look at this kid's muscles. Kid's jacked.
Built like a superhero, Dracula,
and a Power Ranger with a.
Look at little Prince.
Here comes! Oh my God! Here's
look
little
at his
Prince,
boots, dude. He's got Prince.
Oh my Lord! You're gonna have to take a picture of that one. Good Lord!
Look at his
that
little
is
Prince
awesome.
Mustache.
That's great. That is little Prince, man. Kenneth and Jessica just showed up, and they have. A little Prince.
They do. That is the best costume.
And it's great. He's got the tailored purple jacket with the sequin rhinestone, whatever they are, on the shoulder. The
mustache and soul patch really set it off.
Look at his little boots, man. They're like the real Prince boots.
What's that, a cravat?
Cravat.
I think
cravat.
We're wearing the cravat. Same blouse, though.
Yeah.
We are wearing the same clothes.
The same size.
I don't know if anybody caught the references from the names earlier. We are the three amigos here.
We are.
Lucky, Dusty, and Ned Nederlander.
My wife just brought me some sweet tarts ropes.
It's that time of year. You just
so if I'm not on the mic for a minute, that's why.
Hey, that's all right. James is texting. I think I'm just carrying the show here.
You are carrying it. I'm trying
to get
in that.
I think he's uploading some scavenger items we have hidden out here.
There is a
giant for everybody in earshot. We have some scavenger items that are hidden. Caitlin heard.
Yeah, go scavenge those.
That's good.
Absolutely. I just posted it, so we'll see. We'll see how quick those go. I don't know. People are maybe distracted today.
Yeah. Is one of them in the bounce house? Because I want to get in there.
No, I went and jumped on it when it was before they plugged it in. I was like, this is not very good.
They didn't kick you out or anything?
No.
The bounce house is right behind us.
Yeah. It is. It's
so
giant.
I'm sure it's going to get a bunch of action tonight.
It's a pretty big house.
It is a pretty big house.
Grove Hill Farms is right down the way. They've got a pumpkin patch out here. Looks like a little photo opportunity with the pumpkins scattered about.
Who's this behind
us? Amber Bonds is rocking it over there. That's Jeffrey Permenter's with Permenter Electric.
Their pop-up is cool. It's got
they got walls
and stuff.
Yep. I think they have air conditioning, too.
There's some porta-potties over there.
Porta-potties on hand.
Who's that? Whose booth is that?
if I have like any more of this Reese's, it's going to be mine.
A1 Little John, don't get their, do not get their mints. Their mints are not good.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A1-800-786-1725, A1 Little John.
That's a guy, when we were having our house built, he was the provider of that sort of booth.
A1 Little John?
Yep.
Really?
Yep.
Cool.
Good guy to
sounds
know.
Sounds like a good dude.
Yeah. Sounds like the food trucks were supposed to be there this weekend and they backed out. However, there is a cafe now on the square.
There is a cafe. They make burgers.
Make burgers and breakfast, I believe, all day long.
So, it's October 31st, Halloween.
Yep.
What are you guys doing this weekend? Matthew?
I was going to go to Hong Kong, as a matter of fact. I should have been there.
Are you not going?
No, I didn't go because basically I wouldn't have been here. And the flight coming back looked really bad, and I didn't want to get stuck there.
And the two amigos just doesn't work.
Two amigos work, so it's kind of critical that I be here.
Yeah. Well, we got 2/3 of them.
I don't think my wife can fill out your suit.
Yeah. I don't know. As small as these things are.
We might have to do some shuffling.
So, no, unfortunately, I couldn't make it this one. He's got another trip coming up, though, that I might be able to get you a ride to before Thanksgiving.
Jason Voorhees behind you, James.
No, man, I'm not going to look. I'm not going to look.
Don't be alarmed.
Who are y'all scared of? What's the one horror film character that just terrifies you?
Candyman.
Ah, yeah. Good one. Pinhead used to do it for me when I was young. Now it's like just like Democrats.
Yeah,
maybe.
Heard that.
Oh, yeah, I hate that movie.
Heard that.
No, let's see. I think really for me, the movie What Lies Beneath with Harrison Ford horrified me when I was like 17.
Didn't somebody occupy his wife or something?
Yeah, something like that. And also The Exorcism of Emily Rose.
Yeesh. I don't like that kind of stuff.
I don't like that because that's like kind of real maybe.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, The Exorcist is up there for me.
What about you? Oh, you said Candyman. What about
well,
you, Matthew?
Don't say it again.
Oh, yeah.
It's Seaman from here on out. Got it?
I think the Saws get it for me.
Yeah, I don't like
that. Well, not only the character, but the situations they're in is just...
Those are the most uncomfortable movies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of like Final Destination.
Yeah, those are pretty real, man.
Hardcore stuff that you have dreams about. Basically, they took everybody's nightmares, actual nightmares, and made them real.
What did you just point out?
Bo Damsworth.
Oh, yeah. I wish we'd get him on the podcast.
Yeah, let's start grabbing some folks. You want to?
We should. Yeah.
Just randos?
We can, yeah.
That'd
grab
be cool.
some randos if they look like they want to talk.
Yeah. That little girl that walked by a while ago, she was interested.
Yeah, she was. Well, I think she thought we had candy.
Yeah.
But I'm not giving up the stuff that's in front of me. This is for me, actually.
What's your candy? Did you comment the other day on your favorite candy?
Sweet tarts, man.
Yeah.
I like the big chewy ones, the big round ones.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Except they give you the rough gum when you have too many.
They're terrible for your teeth, but I like them.
I remember third grade when they kind of introduced those to my knowledge. The big one, the tablet size.
What's your favorite candy, Matthew?
I'm a Maurice's guy.
Yeah, me too.
Peanut butter is my... Yeah. I bought some peanut butter cookies this past week, and I think I ate them all.
Yeah, I like that. That's my favorite. So there we go. Glad we came to a consensus on that, guys.
Is that a mermaid?
Looks like, yep. Yep.
A little mermaid.
I'd say so.
And a cooter, Bob.
Yeah.
Freddy Krueger coming up.
Hey, there's
female Freddy Krueger.
Slash.
Yeah.
Nice. Lady Slash.
Lady Slash.
Sun feels good. I'm just glad it's not raining.
That sun's fantastic.
How about
that,
guys?
Weather has
it is not raining today. It's beautiful. Perfect night for the Halloween on the square.
I was concerned this morning.
There's another Jason Voorhees.
31 degrees outside. Freddy. It was terribly cold.
Lots of Jasons.
They're scary, man. Jason's hot. There's Batman.
Should we plug our costume idea for next year?
Yeah.
That we just discussed?
Absolutely.
You want to go forward with that?
Absolutely.
Oh,
let's do it.
Yeah.
We thought it'd be cool to next year have a secret flash mob costume for the town. Not sponsored by us, kind of, but coordinated by us.
Yeah.
In which everybody in
town should wear the same thing.
If you want to do it, if you want to be in on this on Halloween on the Square next year,
PM us through the inbox.
Then maybe, we'll create an event for it, for the siren, and it's a secret character flash mob, which what it is, if you request to be part of it, you have to commit to being this character, and it's going to be something easy, something anybody can do, but everybody will show up who knows about this on the same day, on this night, and then we'll all be dressed the same, and it'll look cool to all the people who aren't in on the secret.
So all seven of you listening to
this. You have to make your own.
Yeah, but secrecy is crucial with this. Yeah. So hopefully we can get that going next year, get it going viral on the Facebooks. And how we doing? And get that going. But I thought it was a cool idea.
Somebody finally got her costume.
Yeah, somebody did. I think that is a great idea.
Yeah, that is a good idea. You have to make your own, though. So you can make it like the wind.
Yeah, so like the wind. the idea is it'd be simple and easy, and we can all do, and it'd look cool.
Look at that dude in shorts. What's he supposed to be, a tough guy?
Tough guy. The only problem with that is we got to wait a year to do it.
I know.
I wish we'd had this idea.
Well, no, the
six
problem
months
is
ago.
We got to remember in a year.
Yeah, that's true.
Maybe we should write it down.
We should.
Yeah.
Let's write that down. Well, Mark that.
We did record it.
Mark that.
Good. We are recording.
Oh, man. Oh.
Well,
we should have
get that feeling.
We should put that in the jar just to randomly come up every time. Remember the secret group thing, when we pull it out.
Yeah.
Like, oh yeah.
Dang, people come from everywhere.
You know what? Someone guessed our costume, and I didn't hand them anything, but I should have.
Yeah, I got decals here. I've actually got some limited edition decals.
All right, next person to blurt out what we're dressed like, I'll give you a decal.
Y'all hear that?
If you can hear that, Radio Land.
Some decals up top.
They're not going to hear this until Tuesday or something.
Oh, man.
We've got some out of context 12 o'clock siren quotes coming.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
Decals from some of the favorite guests we've had on the show.
How we doing? I wonder if there's going to be a Garrett Todd experience tonight.
I don't know. He's been a little under the weather lately.
Might poke his head up.
Just for this big event.
Little Toy Story.
Maybe. Man, I'm a little surprised at the amount of people starting to show up.
They're just keeping on filing by.
Yeah. Need to snag somebody that we know. Sorry for the slow talking. I'm looking. I can't do two things at once, apparently.
How loud are we on the street? Are we projecting?
I don't think so. He didn't hook
no,
it up.
No, I don't think it's hooked up.
Okay.
I don't know what the deal is with that.
Good deal.
It's
kind
of weird. We're supposed to have a monitor, and I don't think it's got enough power
coming to
Assassin's
it. Assassin's Creed.
That's what I'm thinking.
This guy right here.
I like it.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yep.
That is a good
Looks one. Good.
Wait till you see my oldest kiddo. He's Link from Zelda.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, cool.
And
where are they at?
What is
well, you kiddos?
What's Walker this year?
Walker's an inflatable T-Rex, like you know, one of the big blow up ones.
Cool.
Yeah.
Kids love those.
Yeah.
It's like the it's lasting long.
Yeah.
The trend. There's Brian Suddeth.
Yeah. Sure enough.
Yeah, man.
There he is.
Sure enough.
He knows how to handle a mic.
Does he? Get him over here.
Drum set. Sit down.
Come on, Brian.
Oh He's man, he gave us head. The cold shoulder. He's like, I don't know about that.
Uh-uh.
I don't know.
That's okay. We'll get somebody.
We'll get him.
We just got to keep throwing that
lure
out.
Looking. He's turning. He's looking
there's
now. Chongaloid. He's giving a second thought.
Look at there.
Hey, there's Jimbo.
Oh, he's looking at Jim.
We're going to get Chonga on here.
Well, there's two mics.
There's two mics. Oh, they're too cool.
They're going to catch up.
They don't want to do it. They don't like it.
There's a Buzz Lightyear and a hot dog.
We'll get somebody for
Superman.
Last year, Walker was an avocado.
Yes,
it
and that was
amazing.
Fantastic.
Oh, that's cool.
He wore it to school today because he couldn't wear his T-Rex.
You wouldn't let him be guac?
Yeah, no, stop. Don't say that. It's terrible. I hate that short name for guacamole.
I hate when people say guacamole. I don't like it.
Oh, man.
Guacamole.
Guacamole. I don't like it.
I know guacamole is extra.
Guacamole is more fun to say.
Yeah.
Waka is...
I like to say guacamole.
If you're saying guacamole, quit it.
Why?
Or guacamole.
I have a question about...
Who says that?
Super Troopers. Two tacos, no guacamoles. Chief, take a chinchilla.
What is it with pronouncing Spanish names with a Spanish accent when you don't have a Spanish accent?
Yeah, it's strange to me.
I don't know.
It's weird. It's very strange.
Cinta Izquierda.
Yeah.
Cynthia Izquierda.
Like, she's got a Southern Texas accent, except when she says her last name.
She took the place of Gloria Campos.
And they, like, roll their W's and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ketchup.
Which, kudos to them.
Here
I
comes
mean,
ketchup.
I'm not that good at it. Oh, ketchup's coming for sure.
Where's mustard?
Could you be ketchup water?
On the other side.
Yeah. You don't want to be.
No, you don't.
There's a hot dog right there. It's got some mustard on it.
Do you put ketchup on your hot dog? Anybody?
No. I don't put anything usually.
Ketchup.
And not because I don't like stuff, just for like streamlining how many I can get down.
Yeah.
Just
like,
nah, don't put anything. Just give me those things.
I'll do mustard and dill relish.
Come here, Chongaloy.
Jimbo's coming up.
Come sit down, dude.
We got a mic and everything.
Got a mic for you.
Come have a seat.
Man.
Our first guest.
Three of me.
Jim McDonald is here.
We have not. You're our first guest. Our first
Jim McDonald, everybody.
Completely random. He's
little
yes. He's getting an
Jim
apparatus. You ready?
Side. Is his
Jim McDonald
side of the mic there, Chonga?
Okay.
Yeah, he's on.
Thank you for having me back on.
Hey,
Jim
man.
McDonald.
Thanks for coming back.
I like it.
Man, I love these costumes. You guys.
Thank you.
Thanks. They're cold.
Are they?
Yeah, they
chilly.
They don't fit very well either.
Yeah,
it's like a tablecloth kind of.
They are very thin.
You're pulling a Tony Kent. You got to get closer to the mic.
Yep.
Yeah, get
sorry
up there.
About that.
It's a drummer thing.
Pull it up.
It is. Not used to being near the mic.
Hold it if you like.
There we go. Drummers
yeah, you can do
typically
this.
Don't sing much.
Yeah.
You can pick this thing up like Steven Tyler style.
Yeah.
Who you
tie a scarf to it.
Who you out here with today?
My beautiful wife and my daughters.
Yeah? What are y'all doing here?
Wife's doing a little booth for the Fannie County Children's Center, so... I said, you know what? I know a little bit about Leonard. I'll come with you.
Cool.
Yeah.
And she said, let's go. Cause
you've actually been here before.
I have.
Did you help her set up the booth?
I did.
Cool.
And
what's your daughter? What's she dressed as? I mean, that's.
I have no idea.
It's a lot of pink.
Just.
I guessed a unicorn
pink
or
stuff.
Maybe rainbow
she
bright of
be
some
a
sort.
Glamour, sparkle princess. So. And then my oldest daughter's supposed to be a scarecrow.
Nice.
I don't know.
There's Martina.
Do y'all remember in elementary school when you wanted to be a punk rocker? Did y'all ever?
I don't remember that.
I always thought that was a big deal.
I was punk rocker.
I was like a zombie punk rocker one year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a big deal.
I didn't have to get a costume because I was already dressing that way.
No. Oh, yeah.
I was also Spuds McKenzie one time.
Ah. Well, and I've peaked because I'm Dusty Bottoms.
You are.
Three Amigos.
I'm Lucky
Day. Yeah, you are.
Yeah. And little Nettie Nederlander over here.
Yeah.
I was a Heaven's Gate cult victim.
That's right.
Or member. I don't know if they
do. You still have those Nikes?
I do. I wore them out, man. I bought them and wore them out.
They're probably worth something on eBay or something now.
I doubt that. There was some generic Nikes there.
The Heaven's Gate didn't bring them fame and fortune?
I don't know. I know a dude that still wears some just like that. Like, he's always worn them since that happened. That's all he wears.
Nice.
He wears them out and he puts them, gets a new pair.
That's cool.
Hey, if you know it works, man, stick with it. What's up, Chongaloid? How you been? Look what I got.
Doing good. I see that. That's awesome.
I'm going to give some of these away to the first people that can guess what we're dressed as.
Oh,
somebody guessed it, but
they walked on by. They didn't. I was trying to hand them stuff.
Oh, man. I was cutting my nose on the mic stand.
I think there's a medical tent
okay?
down there.
Is it bleeding?
Let me see.
Like right here?
No, you're good.
Not here?
You're good.
It might be a little red, though.
Not here or here so much. What is that?
That little rubber band.
It's a purge.
Oh,
a purger.
Is that what that is?
That's a good one.
It's a purger. Look at that little Chewbacca right here.
Chewbacca. He needs one of those stickers.
Who's got the best Chewbacca voice here?
Ooh. Wait.
Chewbacca.
Ooh, that was James. That was good. That was Jim.
Were y'all Matthew. Big into Halloween growing up?
When I was younger.
Because I never got into it, man.
Really?
I was kind of.
I just like to wear makeup.
Oh yeah. I had the plastic mask.
I was really pushing for clowns.
So
but
it
these
wasn't
two
really
go
Halloween
for.
That you were into.
No, I just like wearing makeup.
You had a whole other
any,
thing going.
Any
on.
Excuse.
You get those plastic masks with the little paper thin plastic thing that goes over your clothes. You know.
Staple.
Yeah. No good.
The staple rubber band.
Like a stretchy rubber band string to hold it on your face.
Yeah. I hated it.
Look
man.
At the kids' costumes now. Look at that little Spider-Man behind
you. I can see my breath.
They're actually filming a movie right now, so that's how legit that costume is.
Yeah, he's actually on set.
That's movie quality. There's a Godzilla. Look at that.
Yeah, it's,
Jim can't see it, but there's a Godzilla over there behind the bounce.
It's intense now because you see these guys wearing these like multi-layered costumes or their heads sticking out, and it looks like they're being carried by an alien. You know, and I always kind of get freaked out there a little bit.
What
those are
those
my favorite new
floppy
costumes?
Things,
Jim? See the white ghost thing down there? What is that?
What do you call
those?
Oh, I don't know.
Like car dealerships have them.
I go battle those sometimes. I'll go get a dance off with that.
I've seen that video. I wonder if they should have waited to do the Area 51 raid
look at
today.
That little kid riding a Yoshi.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's that?
You need to go Area 51 right now?
Yeah, well,
yeah, today.
Yeah, speaking alien.
Yeah, because, I mean, it'd give them some distance and some cover because everybody's like, man, that's a really good costume. It turns out he's from, like,
it
some,
also would have been a lot funnier
if
everyone was in random costume.
Yeah. You know?
What if they raided Area 51 today and all the people that work at Area 51 just gave them candy?
Yeah.
When they showed up.
It turned up.
And they're like, hey, thanks. Are there aliens here?
No, but
what
we
do you
got
know?
Peanut butter candy. Yeah.
What do you think the government's giving away?
I don't know. Somebody maybe they're candy. The drug dealers.
Somebody just dabbed on us.
Yeah. Oh, we get a dab?
See that? Yeah.
That's exciting.
There's a stormtrooper. Let me
catch
this guy.
Need to do a segment of scary stories.
I got to give the stormtrooper guy this.
Yeah.
We got a full dress stormtrooper.
Yeah, this is the real deal.
Yeah, there we go.
He's getting a Jimbo limited edition action figure sticker. How cool is that? He's dressed the part.
We got a little
Tinkerbell's getting one, too.
Man, this is a great event out here, guys.
Yeah, this is fun.
See that Tyrannosaurus Rex? That's what I'm talking about.
There's a cop plate.
Oh,
cool.
Yeah. The blow-up Tyrannosaurus. How does it stay? Do you have to inflate it?
It
and
has
then
a battery pack or something.
Ah, that makes a lot of sense.
The T-Rex? The Godzilla is cool, too.
That Godzilla is, that's where it's at, man.
Next year, I'm going to be something warmer like that biker right there.
Oh, that looks like my...
Is that your kiddo?
I don't know. It looks taller than I think it is.
Pretty tall T-Rex.
Yeah.
So the guest...
There's somebody dressed as a dog, and it's really convincing. Oh, that is an actual dog.
That's a dog.
The people keep coming. There's a ton of folks out here.
Well, the next person you get on, you need to have them do, like, a what's the scariest thing that's ever happened to you?
I'm looking for specific costumes.
You know movies pretty well. You want to play a game?
Sure.
All right. You know horror movies pretty well, probably, right?
Yeah, kind of.
You've seen a few?
A couple.
You want to, like, if I just threw some soundtracks up, maybe you think you'd get them?
Maybe.
Even if they're obscure?
Yeah.
You never know.
I am sorry that speaker's not just pumping it out.
Hey, that's all right.
There's a little cap.
I think it's because there's not much output off of this.
Yeah.
I would think.
All right, so we're going to do, you're going to do a song. I'm going to try
I'll
to guess.
I'll see if I can pull up some just scores and songs from famous horror movies that you might know and see if you can get them.
I'm ready.
Kind of creeped out.
What do you got? Oh, that mask, green hair.
Oh, no, I'm kind of creeped out by this music that's coming up. But that thing is terrifying, too. Yeah. What is that? Is that Joker?
I don't know. I don't like it. Have you seen the Joker?
I have not.
No.
I heard it was pretty good.
Pretty good. I like that dude, that Joaquin Phoenix. He's pretty good.
It's kind of depressing.
Is it? It's a standalone ride. It's not going to be
a Batman. They could keep going with it, man. Oh, okay. But I would stay away from that if you're, you know, it's not a family friendly.
Of course, there's no reception here.
Right.
Well, you could hum the song.
Catwoman.
Can you might have to save it. Say a few lines.
Yeah, just sing it for us.
We might have to save it for the Thanksgiving episode.
All right.
There you go.
There's someone dressed as an Enterprise rent-a-truck.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a cool costume.
It's really good.
Whoa.
Sure enough.
I just stuck this mic thing into my eyeball.
Don't cut your nose.
It like went up under my... Yeah. Yeah, I don't want that. There's a lot of Spider-Mans. I see five Spider-Mans within an eye shot.
I was going to call, like, what do you think is the most common that you see out here?
So far, I'm going to go with Spider-Man.
Maybe they're already ahead of us on the secret group costume.
It sure isn't Three Amigos.
No.
No.
Well, there's three of them.
There are three, yeah.
There's three Spider-Mans, so we're rivaling them right now. We're tied.
Best costume.
Wherever there's...
I'm sorry. Best costume.
You just...
knocked the mic over here.
Matthew was about to do his spiel. He's been wanting us to quote Three Amigos movie lines the whole time, and we don't know him as well as he does.
Wherever there's injustice, you will find us.
Did you see Kenneth's kid?
Yes. Wherever there is suffering, we'll be there. You got to finish it.
Hang on.
You got to finish it.
Wait. Hang on. I can't see.
Oh, man.
Line. I'm blowing it.
It's like line. It's the Liberty line. Liberty.
Oh, wherever liberty is threatened, you will find...
A little more enthusiasm, a little more pep, please.
I can't read. I'm dyslexic. All right, you guys, watch the movie, and then you'll know what we attempted.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's amazing. Grady probably should have got this.
We do have a best costume ever award sitting on the table here.
I made it.
To give away. That King Kong is cool.
Going along with...
Godzilla?
Brett's Facebook post. Yeah. We should give that best costume award to just somebody that's not in a costume.
Yeah.
You know? Like, that's a good costume, dude.
Dressed like a modern day Indian.
We should give it to that dog.
Yeah.
There's a spotted dog behind
him. How do you vote on the... You can vote, on the kids?
I shared it. If you just find the picture you like and then click like on it, that's a vote.
James, did you share our group photo to the...
I better do that.
To the chamber?
I will do that now.
When does the voting stop?
I don't know.
Is it the Leonard Chamber of Commerce?
Yeah.
Facebook page?
Yeah. If you go to mine, I shared it, Jungloid.
Okay.
Leonard Chamber of Commerce is doing a great job here, putting this all together.
Yeah, they are. This looks like
really cool.
Everyone's having a blast.
I think there's a petting zoo on the other side. The FFA is
really?
putting together. Yep, it's on the other side from us.
What kind of animals?
Jim, you were
over
there. Can you tell us more about that?
Can you confirm the animals at the petting zoo?
I did not see any animals.
Okay, there may not have been.
I didn't smell any animals.
I'm petting an animal before I leave here today.
But there are tons of people. Bounce houses galore.
Can you navigate to that, Matthew? I'm not sure where to post a picture.
I'm not sure why I just leaned into the mic to clear my throat.
Get confused
I was
sometimes.
Looking away and that.
So do you have to like it or can I love it?
Yeah, you can love it.
I'm loving it.
Love it.
Yeah.
I think it's reactions.
I would like it if you loved it.
Man,
he was blowing it away the last I saw.
66, man.
What's Bear Cub eating?
20. I see that 26. So it appears that young Prince, little Prince, is in the lead right now for the kid costume contest.
If he can maintain that lead, he's gonna have himself a win.
Yeah, absolutely.
I kind of want to go vote on some of these that might have a little bit lower, though.
What kind of crowd do you think is interested? The extremely young crowd seems to be interested. The extremely old crowd, not so much.
Right, yeah.
We get dirty looks.
I know it.
There's my sweet wife.
Kind of wondering where my sweet wife and
her
kids
are. Her hands
are
cold.
I think I got it there, James.
Oh, awesome.
Make sure that's on the right thread.
Oh, yeah. That's it.
That's it, right?
That's it.
Cool. I think we're entered.
I'm going to go ahead and share it to our siren page, too.
Absolutely.
Man. Somebody getting stabbed? Did y'all hear that?
Somebody screaming. They're having fun, I guess.
Just the sounds of Halloween. Yeah. Let it pass.
It's just a speaker. They've got it on a loop over there.
Yeah. Just murder sounds.
Sure, I'm proud of
Jason just pulled out some gloves like a pro.
Now that's what I call murder sounds, volume 18.
It kind of reminds me of the canteen scene when he's like, they're thirsty and he's sloshing the water around and he just spits it out on the ground.
Yeah. He's just bathing in it.
These gloves. But I didn't bring enough for everyone.
Here, I got
oh, man. That would have been nice.
Jungaloid's got gloves. Check him
out. Oh, man. I got a free pair from Uline yesterday.
Man, I can go, like, work on an engine.
What's your favorite gym nickname?
Well, I just call him Jim usually.
Yeah? No Chonga?
Yeah.
I call him Chonga occasionally.
Or Jimmy Chonga?
Yeah, I'll probably do a Jim.
I usually do Jimmy Chonga. That's how I saved in my phone.
Yeah, a lot of people just call me, you know, Jim.
Yeah.
Jim, could you do a
Jim Blaine?
A GMAC voice for us?
I don't know. Man, I wish I could get him up here. I told him to come up here.
There's a Hulk. Incredible Hulk running around with Spider-Man.
That'd be awesome. Yeah. Wish GMAC would come.
I wonder how many times I'm going to hit my earpiece on. Oh, my goodness. Look at that scary clown under the tree. Wait till he turns around.
I can't tell if that's
here.
A
we got an emoji.
Scary clown or
we got the
juggalo.
Hulk.
Yeah. Maybe it's just somebody
who's
Nathan Kent.
Really into ICP.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a juggalo. That's not a clown.
Yeah, he was like, actually, I was just headed to the show, man.
I'm
going
to the gathering of the juggalos here. Driving down.
Look at that thing.
Look at it. Look.
It's like a gorilla clown.
No.
With lots of teeth.
That's rough.
I'm about to have to cart hard up, boys.
Car hard up.
It just dropped 23 degrees in
it
about
did.
2 minutes.
It's chilly.
Just because the sun went behind them trees. It's terrible. I don't like it.
Man.
Can we get Bear Cub on the mic?
Yeah,
Mike.
We can.
Rebecca.
My sister just showed up, too, with her little too.
All right, I'm going to go trick-or-treat, man.
I used to work with
thanks
her.
Thanks for coming by.
Hey, thanks for coming by.
Thanks for coming by.
You out of here, Jim?
I'm going to go get some candy.
Thanks for coming, buddy.
Right. If you come back, bring me some candy.
Get some good stuff.
Have fun out there.
That was Jimmy Chonga, everybody.
See you, Jim.
We got the one and only DJ B-Dash.
Uh-oh, who we have here?
Little baby bear cub. Wow.
Bear Cub is back.
The crowd loves you, man.
Yeah.
What a dude.
Oh, man. Keep it going for Bear Cub. DJB. Keep it going.
What's your no
keep
good?
Keep it going, y'all. Keep it going. Cut it off. Thanks.
Hey, it's nothing I'm not used to.
Yeah.
There he is.
Sunglasses and all, man.
I'm giving out stuff.
We got a couple sirens.
Giving things away.
Siren decals going out. That's good to see.
Here, I'm
going to
give a.
Here's a pink one. Thank you, guys.
Everyone get one?
For those of you listening, we got some decals we're giving away to some folks.
Yeah, we're just handing out stuff. I'm not giving these Butterfingers out, though.
What about those gloves?
No.
No.
I got to say, y'all pick
the
right.
These wouldn't fit to you anyway, bro.
B, what you up to?
Y'all pick the right uniforms for today.
What's that, Bear Cub?
Full suits.
Yeah.
Keep warm.
Well, half suits.
Yeah. Wow. I said,
I have a bear midriff, if you can't tell this thing.
I wanted to be Michael
down.
Phelps, but they said no.
Yeah. Y'all wanted to get matching tattoos. Olympic tattoos on your waist?
Yeah. Oh, man.
Man, there are a lot of people here.
Yeah, we were going to be Summer Olympians.
Yeah.
Is that Keith? Yep. Mr. Griffin.
So. What's up? All these famous people.
Oh,
wow. Look at this guy.
You're the famous guy.
I recognize you with all the
take,
blood over your
take
face.
One of these.
Yeah.
Stick it on something.
You want to sit down?
Yeah. He wants some kickbacks.
Okay, but you got a Jeep now?
Wearing the fly racing gear?
Yeah, I got to, bro.
Who are you?
Mr. Keith Griffin just walking away.
I haven't seen that cat in years.
Didn't recognize him with the long hair.
Yep.
The crowd is loving it.
Middle mile.
You think this guy wants a He-Man?
Yeah, Joe, that's a good Joker outfit.
That is a good Joker.
All right, so has anybody asked?
That is a good Joker.
Has anybody asked, like, what's the best costume I've seen so far?
Scream's
coming. Just in a few, like, 40
minutes. That's what we're trying to figure out.
Spot it open, because I've seen some very good ones. I have to say that my favorite so far, I'm going to do a little shout-out to Kenneth Fuller and Jessica, because I saw Prince walking around here.
Yeah.
Boy.
Baby Prince.
About the first one we saw.
I was jealous.
I know it sounds a little biased, but he might be deserving of this.
Yes,
best
I know.
Costume ever.
Oh, y'all got
I was just
now,
thinking
okay.
the same thing. I hate to give it to family, but I think it's very deserving.
It was top notch. Did you know about this?
Coming off the heels of the Hulk Hogan last year.
Okay.
I mean, they know what they're doing.
I think prior to Hulk Hogan was Beetlejuice.
And that was the best.
His first year, he was Baby Elvis.
Nice.
Yeah, Fat Elvis.
So they obviously put some stock in this, right?
Yeah, she makes them all, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's cool.
I was about to say, I hope she knows she's, like, putting herself on a pedestal for, you know, like, next year. Now I'm waiting because I'm realizing, okay.
Yeah, the only
Travis Croley, how you doing?
Now I'm waiting.
What up? What's up, fellas?
Mr. Travis Croley.
What's up? What's going on, my man? Doing all right? Doing good?
How are you?
Here, what's up, brother? How are you, man?
Have one of these. Have one of these, Trav.
How are you guys?
Get a little decal.
Yeah, man.
We're live direct, baby.
Live podcast.
We are live.
Happy Halloween, guys.
Check us out. Halloween.
Mr. Yeah. Travis Croley walking away.
This is what we like to call community outreach.
Yeah.
Dude,
yeah.
Is it just me or is that clown staring at me? I think it's staring at me.
They're all staring at you.
Here it comes. Now, oh, my gosh. I'm out of here, dude. I think I may know who this is.
Keith Griffin's family is dressed up as tech.
This award like. Just so he won't hurt me.
Right.
Oh, yeah, that is creepy.
All right.
That's a good one.
Now he has coming over here.
Who are we?
My man.
What's up,
who
buddy?
Yeah.
My man.
Who is it? What's going on? No, but we're scared of you.
Have one of those.
There you go.
Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
That is my down-the-street neighbor.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. He's a cool cat. He brought me barbecue.
Cool.
Hey.
Oh, man. Yeah.
That's a good neighbor to have.
You think he's got some barbecue in there?
Next time I make something I'm really proud of, I'm going to take it to him.
There's Phillip Grintz, and case you're in.
No way.
Yeah.
Old Philly cheesesteak. Can we get a round of applause for Phillip?
Phillip Grintz, everybody. He's shaking hands with everybody, meeting and greeting. How you doing? Keep it going for Phillip Grintz, everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, James Hartley getting a handshake. You want to sit in?
You want to sit in?
Grab that mic.
You want a microphone, Phil? You want to get on the air?
Is it live today?
We're going.
Hop on there. Hop on there. Put the headphones on.
We're going live as a podcast can. Oh, easy, we got a chair, too. We got a chair for you.
We do have an extra chair. And we have a lot of candy, but this is mine.
So you got to get up close to that mic.
We're going to have to bump mics.
No, you got.
There's a mic right there. He's got his own.
Yeah.
You may have to hold it, Philly. You got to talk in the side like this.
Talking to the side?
Yeah.
So where you been?
Philip Grant's in the house back in Ale Town.
Oh, California.
California, what part?
San Jose.
Oh cool. Wow. Yeah, you dodging poop on the sidewalks out there?
Not bad there.
Fires
not
and stuff, there. Right?
Yeah.
Were there any fires near you, Philip?
Nope.
No?
It's all L.A.
That's like in the wine country right now, right?
It's close to it.
Is it?
Yeah, southwest of it, right? So
I don't know. I think so. I don't know my California very well.
Brentwood is what I heard.
Philip, you seen any cool costumes?
I just got here.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
There's cool.
Oh,
man. You get Prince without wig.
Oh, hey.
She dropped her.
Jessica.
The wig.
You dropped your wig.
Hand down.
Yeah, you don't want to lose that.
Uh-uh.
Prince wouldn't be Prince without his flowing locks.
So what are you doing out in California?
Remodeling
the
hotel.
Oh, nice, nice. Have you made it south of San Jose at all? You gone down to Big Sur or Central Cali?
No, I made it to Santa Cruz.
Oh, okay. Yeah, nice. It's
Oakland.
Yeah, that's a destination city.
Oh, yeah.
I went to Oakland last year, and it smelled like urine.
Mm.
No. So
nasty.
So not much has changed.
No.
Did it smell like that when you went there, Bear Cub?
Yes.
Yeah. There's Goldberg.
No,
Bill Goldberg just looked at me.
He's with Garney Construction.
I got a lot of looks today, man. The clown's been staring me down. Now Goldberg. Here comes Buckethead again.
Buckethead. Let's see that. Oh, that's a marshmallow guy.
No. Is that a marshmallow? I want it to be Buckethead.
Yeah, that's just because you know, sorry. It
would be funny.
Yeah.
Philip, tell me a story, man. What's up?
Philip is dressed up as Michael Young.
What's we got two guests on. What's
Michael
your favorite
Young
scary
right
movie?
Better than Josh Hamilton.
Yeah, I was going to say him, but I refrained.
Oh, yeah.
Because he doesn't look like Josh Hamilton at all.
No, well, I was going to say, he's dressed as a child beater because he's in Ranger.
Yep.
Never mind.
Yep.
Sorry.
New information is out.
Yeah.
It's true.
Is it true? It's confirmed?
Yeah.
His wife has a...
Oh, confirmed? Oh, I know he's in... Well, he turned himself in.
How the mighty have fallen.
Boy, too bad, man.
That guy's got a story, that's for sure.
He does. What is that? Death face.
Grim Reaper in...
Is it?
A Grim Reaper in New Balances.
All of these costumes like that, I think, is Sam Croley, but it's not. We haven't confirmed that it's Sam yet.
Is it bad to say that I believe Josh Hamilton will be like weeks away from a really big signing deal?
He might, yeah.
Maybe.
I mean, I thought that we quit a while back, but.
Yeah, maybe. You never know. Yeah, he will have a book deal. You're right, Philly. I need you to say that into the microphone next time.
Looks like he's dressed like a New York jogger in the hoodie.
Yeah.
I got to say the one great thing about Halloween, if you're out
that
early
guy's in a
day,
racing
Halloween,
suit, that's pretty cool.
It's a great day to make fun of just normal people walking around in regular suits.
Yeah. Tell that story.
The true story. I made up. I was actually sitting up a gig earlier today, and a guy walked in a blue suit. And I just thought to myself, oh, very nice, Austin Powers. And realized he was just coming in for lunch.
We're just talking about cravats.
We were. Matthew butchered the pronunciation.
Yeah. Ooh. Called it a crouton or something.
Yeah.
We're getting a lot of love on our Three Amigos Facebook post. And,
are we?
Scott just posted a GIF.
Oh, there it is, whatever. The dance.
Yeah. Three Amigos dance.
If Scott's listening, we actually rehearsed the dance before this.
We did.
We're going to have to build a 12 o'clock siren fire right here pretty soon, man.
I know.
It's getting a little nerpily.
It is
you
chilly.
Cold, Brett?
It is chilly.
Phillip's
ski jacket on.
You cold, Phillip? This is your weather, isn't it?
Yep.
You like it
it's
like
not
that.
Bad.
Man.
The sun is no longer on my back.
There's a Chucky.
It will be here shortly for a brief moment.
Look at this Chucky right here.
Have we seen
coming
any
at
popular,
there's a
Joker
Weezer.
So far has been the popular costume I've seen.
Here comes a Weezer and a Nirvana and a Chucky.
Jason says Superman.
Spider-Man.
What's that?
Spider-Man,
sorry,
yeah. Spider-Man.
The most popular costume
Spider-Man,
so far.
Superman or something, I wouldn't pay
Spider-Man.
Attention.
Spider-Man.
Is that Chucky? Very good Mr.
Yes.
Rogers the other day.
That is Chucky.
Yeah.
Very well done, Mr. Rogers.
You see the DJ that I tagged you in?
No, not
the
yet.
Kid, the kid, this guy said he made this little Bluetooth speaker DJ system for his kid. That went off his stomach.
Oh, really?
But it was a little two-deck system. And, that's I mean, he had the headphones, and, yeah, it looked like a DJ. It was pretty cool.
What's the kid in the purple hair?
Chucky. Chucky and a Spec Ops.
Oh, my God. Chucky's terrifying.
Little Spec Ops.
Little Spec Ops guy?
Yeah.
That's not a wig.
That's a good one.
Captain America.
Chucky's rocking that suit with a lot of confidence.
Chucky
man.
And Skechers.
Like, he's been waiting to wear it.
Yeah.
You know, and might wear it to school after.
Yeah.
I'm just going to call everybody what they're wearing and then their shoes. So Chucky and Skechers. We've got
so
Grim Reaper in New Balances.
I'm Dusty Bottoms and Chucks.
Yeah. Lucky
yeah.
Day in Nikes.
Look at Bear Cub giving away some TTOS swag.
Team, yeah.
Thank
you.
You. Thank you. What is that guy? He's a Christmas thing. Snowman.
Snowman. That's a good one.
I like the confidence that some of these people have in their costume because I do not share that confidence in mine.
Did you hear about
does
what?
Does it fit well?
Philip, did you hear about what we're going to do for Thanksgiving?
Nope.
Yeah, we're going to have a big old charity event across the street at the Cowboy Corner. You familiar with the Cowboy Corner, right?
I am.
We're going to have a Toys for Tots drive. We're going to hook up with a little charity here in town and try to get as much cash for donations as we can to donate for toys for kids this Christmas. Jason, am I right?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
You want to add in on that?
What's that?
You want to add in on that?
Well, right now we have an idea and we have a date.
Yeah.
November 30th, it's a Saturday. It'll be in the evening time. A
couple days after Thanksgiving.
All we really know is we want to get some Christmas gifts for some local kiddos. So if you have any ideas, if you want to be a part of that, please reach out and let us know.
Yeah. No, I think this is going to be one of our big fun events. Oh, we got somebody else joining us.
Oh, Philly's leaving.
Yeah.
We got Miss
Stanley
coming.
Thanks for coming by, Philip. We appreciate it.
Hey, Philip. It's good seeing you, man.
See you, Philip.
Yeah. But keep it going for Miss Sheryl Stanley.
Sheryl Stanley.
Yeah.
Have a seat.
Hey.
You may have to hold your microphone.
You can pull that chair in.
Tuck in the side like this.
Or just pull the microphone down in your lap and sit back, actually. That's actually the best way to do it.
Yeah, just bring it to you.
That's the best way to do it.
Thank you, guys.
Are you there? Talk into the side as close as you can get it to your mouth.
Miss Stanley, how are you? Can
I'm
you hear
great.
Us?
How are y'all doing?
We're doing terrific.
We're awesome. little
you have
chilly.
A booth set up over there?
Yes, with First United Bank.
Let's
cool.
hear about it.
Y'all been busy?
Yes, we do all kinds of stuff. Loans.
See you, Philip. Thanks
accounts.
For stopping by.
Cool. Tons of people over there?
Yes, in fact, we're running out of candy.
The kids are
going
to want to know
I think
what candy
they've been
are y'all handing out.
Really busy over here. What are y'all giving away?
They were giving away candy and bracelets. Sure what else.
Just other Chotskys.
I was busy talking.
Cool.
I'm actually hoarding candy. I'm not giving it out. I'm collecting it.
Matter of fact, we were just talking about a charity event we're wanting to do across the street. here at Cowboy Corner over Thanksgiving.
You may have some input. We want to raise some Christmas gifts for some local kiddos. We're not exactly sure which who we should donate to.
Jason's done something like this in the past, in which I think you dealt with Ava Barlow.
I did deal with Ava, and that was for the Leonard Child Advocacy Program.
Yep.
But that's been a handful of years ago, so right. I'm not sure now what the best...
There's a Toys for Tots. Gay Dole is the head of that.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Perfect.
We're going to do free pictures with Santa on the at the Christmas parade.
Okay.
With donations to toys. It's like bring a free unwrapped toy.
Now, what would be best for us if we have our friends get together? Should we do cash donations or gifts, unwrapped boy, girl, toys?
They take all of them.
Okay. Great. Great. So
we're
there you
thinking
go.
About doing a Toys for Tots drive that would go to local kids is what
That'd
we're wanting
awesome.
To do. And we're thinking about November 30th, guys. Mm-hmm. Am I right on that?
Yep. Yep.
November 30th from like 5, it's a Saturday, from like 5 o'clock to midnight. And, you know, we'll just set up with some, I talked to Hannah
today, building?
Actually.
Did
I
you?
Saw her at Knucklehead. But we're trying to talk to Bluebonnet and see what they might be able to help us out with if they want to be a part of it.
Yeah, we're
going
to put some feelers out to everyone and see who wants to be a part of it. And that, I guess that'll dictate how big it gets. So
try to do a little catered mixer, I guess.
Right.
You know, I mean, a very small scale and rough means in the building. But do something like that where everybody can kind of donate to the community and have a good time as well.
Very good.
Yeah, we want to help out.
All
we want
to help is
make sure kiddos have a good
Jason
Christmas.
Jason has kind of organized a similar party in the past in which it took off pretty well.
Yeah,
and they got
I
a
did,
pretty good reaction.
Once before I tried this just kind of on a whim and it worked out, and we're going to try it again a little more organized this time.
That'd
be
great. That'd be
much what'd y'all do last time?
We had kind of a Thanksgiving gathering. We had folks show up, and it was mostly cash donations. And I think amongst 40 or 50 people, we raised over $700. So
yeah. So
yeah. So it'd be fun.
So
a lot of fun.
Gay Dole on that one?
Yes.
Okay.
She's the chair for that.
We'll seek out Gay Dole.
And you're working on the upcoming Christmas parade?
Yes, sir.
All right. So what have you got so far?
Yeah.
Can you tell us any details?
Yes. We had a very large donation, and we're having, for the first time, we're having a community Christmas tree. It should be here tomorrow. It's 16 feet tall.
Mm.
And then a big starburst at the top is 3 feet tall. So we're looking at 19 feet tall.
Nice.
Cool.
We're going to put it in front of City Hall.
Cool.
Have a lighting ceremony before the parade starts on December 7th at 6 o'clock.
December 7th at 6 o'clock.
Yes.
The lit up.
Yes, we are going to light it up. The parade will be lighted also. We're recognizing
Oh, so we're
Harvey
doing nighttime this time.
For the, yeah, for cool. those of you not realizing what time that is, that will be nighttime.
Yes.
So we'll have a nighttime parade
Very
here
cool.
on the square.
Yes.
Very cool.
I think we'll have a little Jeep crew coming with the lights and stuff, too.
Yeah,
I'm excited.
It's looking to be a really big parade.
My mom and I just got a bunch of stuff for our Jeeps yesterday, matter of fact.
Yeah? You know, Christmas stuff to decorate them?
Yep.
Cool.
Awesome.
Very cool.
What? Anything else on it? I
yes,
mean,
yeah. We're going to have some festivities after the parade. We've got several businesses that are going to set up booths. We've got hot cider, hot chocolate, ornament decorating, cookie decorating.
Cool.
I know we've got popcorn vendors, maybe some cotton candy.
Cool.
And then we've got caroling from some of the school choirs.
Right on.
Very cool.
So it should be a good evening. Just hopeful for the weather.
What time do you think that's going to go till?
Probably about 6 to 8.
Okay. That'd be fun. I guess that's a Saturday?
That is a Saturday. Yeah. Actually, the LHS band boosters are going to do a 5K. They're calling it a jingle jog about 3 o'clock that afternoon to kind of kick everything off. So.
Cool.
So hopefully for
Very
a great
cool.
day in Leonard, Texas.
That'd be
right
fun.
On. Who's next to you over there at the your bank booth? Who is
Garney,
your neighbors?
Garney Construction
okay.
Was just south of us. They've got a pretty neat little setup there. And they've been a great contributor.
Yep.
it
messes
to
me up too.
to our Christmas funds.
There's
so,
a very large chicken over there.
Them also, but
excellent. Who else next to you?
You know, I don't know.
Yeah,
Matthew.
I was talking
didn't,
to
didn't
everybody.
You, didn't you write the map?
Don't put her on the spot like that. Hey, let's get, can we get your favorite scary movie before you leave?
I don't like scary movies.
I don't either.
I'm going to
okay,
pull,
your
I'm
most
gonna pull
hated one
question out of the jar. Just a random question.
You want to do a question?
We'll go me. Absolutely random here. I'm just going to
Scary
movies see what
throws
it is.
Me back to elementary school.
Here we go.
Clint Hinesley.
Yeah.
Leprechaun.
Oh, right. Yeah.
This is easy. Best childhood memory.
My best childhood.
Your best childhood
memory.
Childhood
memory.
Actually, you know that I've been thinking about that. I think that came up on one of your other podcasts.
Yeah.
And I think it was about Leonard. And my one of my favorite memories was when I was young. We used to go to football games, and you could pull in the vehicles inside the football field.
Oh, wow.
And I remember I was on the twirler team, and we got to perform out on the field. And then that Archie White ran a kickoff back.
Oh,
and I
wow.
remember that. I've been listening to y'all, wow. and I remember
cool.
all of that.
Cool.
So
that's
that's
awesome.
One of my favorite memories.
Right
that's
on.
A good one. That's a good segue into Archie White, because we want to dig more into that guy.
Absolutely. So you could just pull your truck right up to the
cool.
kind of fence line and,
yes, and
back in and tailgate.
Yeah, where they have it
cool.
paved now,
yep.
yeah. you could pull in.
Oh, that's cool.
And the concession stand was under the home
yep.
bleachers.
Yep. I kind of remember.
It always had yellow lights.
I remember remnants of it underneath the stands.
Yeah.
Cool.
That's
yeah,
cool.
Before the trees then. Before the trees? The
no,
trees?
No, I don't remember getting nah,
trees. I don't know about that. They've been there since I've been there.
Right, like, they must have been there forever. They're huge.
Yeah, they are big.
As long
they
as I know.
Been little then. I don't know.
I wish I could pull my Jeep in here
ago.
Right now.
Turn
this
the heater
is,
on.
This
get in
is
there
certainly a good
door.
Turnout.
It really
don't
is.
You think?
Yeah,
what are what are the numbers on it? Do you know any of them? I'm sorry.
300 to 400 kids.
Yeah. Cool. So
while we've got you,
600 people.
Yeah.
While we've got Sheryl, let's hear a little bit about all of her duties. She's responsible for a lot of the stuff that we have here. Is that
she
correct?
Is. Yep.
The parades
oh.
and
she does quite
you know,
a bit.
I've been fortunate. I'm part of the chamber, Leonard Chamber of Commerce, and I handle the Easter egg hunt every year, and then basically the parades, the picnic parade back in July, and this is my first Christmas parade. So. Just trying to make it bigger and better each time. So
the picnic parade was great, if that's any indication of how Christmas will go.
Cool. Yeah.
I think you're in good shape.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'm excited for
so.
It.
It's all about the weather in December.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It could be like this, and it could be nasty.
Yeah. It could be 75 and warm.
Yep.
Yep.
You never
it
know.
Sure
we got lucky today.
Yeah, we did.
Dodged a bullet, I think. It's a little chilly,
James,
but
James, you all right, buddy?
Yeah.
Last year
you haven't spoken
raining.
A while. I didn't know if your mic was still on.
Taking it all in, man. Taking it all in.
Yeah,
there's
last
a
year
lot.
Was really raining.
Oh, wow, look at that guy. Do you, oh, somebody's a
that
port. Somebody
a
is
porta
a
potty.
Oh, man, that, okay. All right. This one, I think we can all agree.
That's great.
I think we can all agree the porta potty guy that we were just talking about dressing as a porta potty, were we not?
We have to get a picture of that guy.
Let's say we were.
That is greatness. Oh, man. Yeah,
that's
he's
funny.
The winner. Hands down. I'll give it to
yeah,
him right
that's
now.
That's great. Sorry, Grady.
An hour and 4 minutes into it, and we went potty joke.
I would say he's number one, but he's really number two.
We've already
put a potty. Am I right, Sheryl?
Okay, so
am I right, Sheryl?
Okay.
There's
so.
Ben Kent.
Checking
so.
On that.
Oh, yeah. We need a picture of it.
Yeah, we've got to get the porta potty over here.
Oh, there
he's
it is. I want to see one with
the door. So he's got a guy carrying a porta potty.
Chicken is impressive, too.
Yeah.
Oh, man, it's so good.
Have him turn this way so we can see with the door open, see him screaming inside.
He's got to win. He could win the group and individual.
That is pretty good.
Yeah, that's good.
Depending on his age, he could
there.
Clean up.
Have you seen the attractive dancer type that has the the costume where she's on
Sheryl,
Trump's
do you have
shoulders.
A siren decal?
No.
Oh, man. It's good.
Oh, okay.
It's good. She's all, like, dancing. It looks like he's carrying her on her shoulders. It's funny.
I love the shoulder ones. They're my
yeah.
favorite.
Yeah.
Sheryl,
yeah.
do you have any other news or events coming up you want to plug? Do you listen to the show?
I do listen
awesome.
To the show.
Awesome. Thank
podcast.
You very much. Do you have a favorite interview or anything? A favorite episode?
You know, I kind of like Fletcher's a lot.
Yeah,
Fletcher's
is good.
That was the quarterback.
Cool.
For that
what's up, David?
Championship team.
David Sutter is right behind you. Watch out. I'm going to give him a little round of applause.
Sorry, we interrupted.
No, it's
David,
all right. You like Coach Fletcher's?
Don't be offended if
yes,
we blurt.
Yes, I mean, of course, you know, talking about the 2013
yep.
Football team.
Yep, you had
I followed that really
you had
closely.
Kids in school then, right?
I had a nephew that was the quarterback.
Okay, there
so.
You go.
Right on.
Right.
Sorry for not knowing everything.
Who's yeah, your nephew?
Justin Bennett.
Oh, okay.
Awesome.
Cool.
That was a
yes.
fun episode.
Sounded like a good.
And I'm a big sports person.
Oh yeah,
so.
It's that man. It's looking like they could have a run like that this year. They're
yeah,
they're getting hot at the right
really
time.
Yeah.
Stay tuned as well. We'll have more Coach Fletcher, I'm sure, and among some other sporting
right.
notables.
Absolutely.
We'll see.
Volleyball too.
They're yeah,
doing really well in volleyball.
Yep.
I love Fletch, man. He's a lot of fun. He was a great guest too. Did you check that one out?
Oh, yes.
She said that was her favorite.
That was her favorite.
I was looking around at porta potty people and stuff. I'm sorry.
You've been to the football games. Is Fletch doing the bark, the dog bark?
He
the throat bark. You hear that ever?
He did.
The tiger spell
something
out?
Very similar.
Fletch, if you're hearing this, I want to bring it back. You know?
He did something very similar when they beat Blue Ridge towards the end of the game.
Okay.
When Leonard had it sewed up, he did something.
So they don't do the tiger spell out anymore?
I don't think so.
Was that a coach that did that, or was it?
No, it was around for a long time through several coaches. It just kind of.
Do you know what we're talking about, Sheryl?
It's gone the way of the drill team, I'm afraid.
One night we were at.
Isn't that sad?
One night there was a bunch of us at the Becknell's house, and we were having a good old time, and there's a bunch of rowdy guys, and we all got together to do this tiger spell out. It was the funniest thing at the time, but.
I hate that it's died.
Based on your reactions, you don't get how funny it was.
There's my
James's kiddo.
Zelda, no, Link, sorry.
We got to hear how it goes.
That's, can you tell?
Look at those ears.
Oh.
Why, it just showed up.
Yeah.
The Hartley clan is here, everybody. Say, give them a round of applause.
All of Bailey.
Yeah.
All of Bailey just showed up.
Two-thirds of Bailey.
Come here.
Walker is a giant T-Rex.
Hey, say hello. Say
looking
hello.
Good.
No.
Miss Ashley's here too.
Yeah.
Hey, it's Mike and Janie.
Oh, sorry.
Kiddos looking
here.
Good. Ooh, what do we have here? This is the most unique. I got a rainbow colored tutu.
What is
no.
That?
An umbrella cloud. Rainy a rainy cloud.
That's nifty.
Holding a pail.
Oh, no, that's great.
Rainbow.
It's pink ladies,
it's a cloud
that's
raining cool. With a rainbow.
James is stepping away
and
from the
rain
mark.
Boots. Am I missing something?
I'm not sure what that is. I think that's a
I'm
good
confused.
Attitude on
that's
a rainy
that's
day.
A pretty cool,
if I had to
it's
guess
a, it's
what
a
that
pretty
is.
Cool effect. I dig it.
Hey, yeah. I need to backtrack, but I was going to say earlier with the porta potty costume, Jessica Jones, next year I want Hulk carrying Prince in a porta potty.
Yeah,
she can make that happen.
Sorry.
Jeffrey Pimenter walking by.
She can definitely make that happen. There's Holly. What's up, Holly?
Holly Hancock's
in. You got a decal?
She's a Leonard Tigerette cheerleader. My sister's walking
what,
by
what
with
color
her
you want?
Two.
We got some whites.
I got a Pikachu.
Pinks. I think I gave all the blues away. You have to go white.
Jessica's dressed up like a
cheerleading outfit.
There's Hallball. You still fitting that thing?
Still fitting it.
The Prathers are here. All the Prathers are here. How we doing?
That's awesome. What's going on?
Check out my sister's family
Anthony
there. Stranger Things.
Anthony Prather dressed up like the cowboy.
Stranger Things.
No, he's the sheriff from Stranger Things. It took me a while to get everybody.
Yeah,
but,
he's Hopper.
They did actually a very good job on this.
My little niece is 11.
I know. I told her if she wanted to go dedicated, she had to shave that head, though, you know.
Out of context quotes from the 12 there. O'clock siren.
There we go.
That's what that is. Does that make sense to you, Sheryl?
Gorillas in Kansas.
Gorillas in Kansas.
We're trying to introduce something new here, and it's called Out of Context Quotes.
I think
quotes.
You guys should have went for a group.
Is that the school?
So,
that's cool.
Mr.
School?
Kegans did actually say there are gorillas in Kansas.
Talking about mascots.
Now, he did. It was on the show.
That was awesome.
And I haven't gotten his authorization to use his quote out of context, but I think it's a funny idea.
Yes,
I'm going to clear it with him. I've also got one from Arvis Buchanan as well. Would you like to see it?
Awesome. Yes.
Here it is. You want to read it in there?
Waylon, I don't have time to go to Toka.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, can you imagine how that came up?
I don't know.
But it came up. So we're going to introduce some limited edition, out of context quote decals.
Awesome.
So
let's see,
just a little fun thing I thought about doing. You want to get back to your booth?
Yes,
I'm sure we're holding
you
up.
So much.
Thank you very much, Sheryl. Thank you very much, Sheryl, for coming by.
Can I have this candy? You got taco seasoning in there?
And
who's giving away taco
thanks
seasoning?
Thanks for bringing a bucket of candy for us. That was very nice.
Oh, man.
Are they really?
Yeah.
That's great.
I got to make my way. Thank
hello.
You, Sheryl.
Oh, look at this. Michael Daugherty sitting down.
Have a seat, Michael.
Past guest coming up.
Friend of the show, Michael Daugherty, is going to be on
wear
camera, too.
James's headset. There's Chandra.
This thing's popping, man.
Yeah.
You're good? Oh.
Hey, I got you something. Would you like He-Man or G.I. Joe? These are Chonga originals.
Man, I can just get one?
You have to choose. We don't have enough to give you a bunch.
He-Man. Like this? Okay.
You want the He-Man?
Yeah.
Take that. That's pretty cool.
I'm going to stick that on one of my guitars.
I got that from the lowbrow hoedown. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Man, I had to... I played a funeral that day.
Yeah,
that time.
That's too bad.
I was trying to get over there because there was a few things that I wanted, but yeah. I couldn't make it.
Jim had a lot of stuff that I wanted. I just couldn't afford it all. I didn't bring enough cash.
Commission him for a couple of
you
things.
He'll make customs. I do know that about him.
You still in the studio?
Yeah, I haven't been since I've talked to y'all. I started a new job, and it's just really demanding. So I have
take a little
really
too much time.
Yeah, but it's coming. Maybe in the next week or two.
Cheryl left her candy.
I think it was because I joked saying thanks for leaving your bucket of candy for us.
Did Cheryl?
I think Jason said something to you about maybe on Thanksgiving doing a little ditty.
Yeah, I told him I'd do a set if you want me to.
We just told Sheryl Stanley just left.
Still here.
We talked to her. We talked to her about doing a little thing, told her about it, and said you might be able to do something for us. So that'd be fun. We'll keep you posted on that. This is all just coming. We're announcing stuff now. But I know you got a wife and kids out here. If you need to go, you're free to take off.
They were talking about us over there.
They're probably wondering where you are.
Yeah, I'm going to jump out, man.
Well, cool. Good. Thanks for hollering at us for a sec.
Thanks
appreciate
for stopping
it.
By.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll catch up with you later.
I'm telling you, man, it is busy here.
Yeah, it is.
Lord. Anthony Prather's looking at it like he wants to get on here.
Anthony wants on.
Where's Anthony?
No, I think he's just looking at Michael.
I think he's always got that look.
Anthony is dressed as Hopper from Stranger Things.
I love it.
In fact, my sister's entire family, I think, is Stranger Things.
How are you?
This is Janie Hartley.
There's Sam.
What's up?
There he is. Oh.
We're small,
how are you, buddy?
We're small but strong, Janie.
We are
Bailey, Texas.
Now.
Sam Croley dressed
Sam,
up as is that the?
That's a Jimbo original.
What? Dope.
Sam's got the.
Sam. He's got the cool out. The Spicoli.
Yeah, definitely Spicoli.
What's up, Sam? You want to sit down for a sec?
Yeah.
Pop these headphones on.
Welcome, Sam.
Yeah, here you go, Sam.
Hang on, over here.
Pop
have a
those
seat.
Headphones on there. And then you may need to hold this.
We're welcoming Sam Croley, and James is back.
Oh, they're on the side.
Yeah, sorry, I had to go visit with my folks for a while.
That's all right. You get warmed up walking around?
Scoot your chair up.
Yes.
There you go.
Man, I'm missing all these costumes. Sam, can you hear us?
Yeah.
Sam, talking to the side right here.
How long you been here so far?
I just walked up.
Yeah?
I walked up to meet Travis, but I guess he already left.
Yeah, he was walking around.
We just saw him pass by.
We seen
maybe
your brother, Travis.
Minutes ago.
He had his daughters. That was my excuse to be here. So now I'm just a grown-up man here by myself.
Now you're just dressed up, having a good time, getting candy.
Matthew's going to fly the drone for a minute.
So I saw Michael over here, but he stopped
had to go.
In.
Yeah, he had
just
to
a
go.
Quick dip. Yeah.
He had to go. So what's up, Sam? What's your
dude,
favorite
I'm digging
costume?
Y'all's costumes, man. Yeah. Mariachi.
Three amigos.
Three amigos. Oh, okay, word. Okay.
Cool.
But they were dressed as mariachis.
He thought they were just mariachis.
That's what I was thinking.
I told Matthew I was going to come as just a big bush, and I'd just start singing as I'd walk up.
What is your? Are you wearing a costume, Brad?
No. Actually, you know what? Maddie pulled a good joke on me. She watches Hocus Pocus, and she asked me earlier, she was like, what are you dressed up as, New Kids on the Block?
Oh, man.
And I thought, this seven-year-old just called me out, and I was like, what the heck?
Burn.
And I realized where she got it from, Hocus Pocus.
Boom, roasted.
Yeah, she got me.
Boom, roasted.
Boom, roasted. She got me.
Three amigos, that's funny.
Yeah, she gets me a couple times.
Thank you.
Right.
Have you seen any costumes you like, Sambo?
Dude, I parked over there and I just did a beeline straight over here to y'all's to Matt's deal over here.
We seen a dude walking around carrying a porta potty. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was a good one. Was that his costume or was he just
that was his costume.
No, he just really had to go.
It was great.
He was just
he had to go, but he didn't want to miss anything.
He was like, hey, I'm late. I heard y'all needed this. Where?
Not only is it a good costume, it's functional.
It is.
Yeah.
I'm going to go find him. I'm going to go find him. Be like, dude, perfect. Need to use you.
Hey, if you can find him, bring him back because we want to give him this.
Oh, word. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if you
is
do happen to see him.
Has it been voted?
I think so. I think we kind of agreed on it. If we don't, then Grady should get it, I believe, so far.
But he's probably going to win the other one. So.
Yeah.
Hey,
good
is good,
man. I know I sound a little biased here, but if it's creative and good.
I mean, I saw it and I was like, oh, that was.
There's been some spooky ones. I know that. I wish that guy would stand back in front of the sun again. Go back. Go back.
I don't know. I need the warmth. Move your head back a little bit, Brett.
There we go. Here
you're
you
my
go.
Sunshade.
Brett doesn't have a big enough head to block the sun.
Hey, man.
We need the other Harvey.
He doesn't either.
Sam looks like a voodoo dude.
Yeah,
Is that what you are?
Well, what's his name? He's got a
witch doctor or something.
So I got home and I was like, I was over at Hannah's house, and I was like, I'm gonna be a skeleton. So I started doing my face white and I did a skeleton thing. And then I went to my mom's and she was like, "Oh, you look like a voodoo witch doctor." And she's
like,
and
"Yes,
and
exactly."
No, yeah. Then she gave
so
me the,
added to it.
Then she gave me the top hat, and then then Travis had on this bandana, and then I went over to Billy Hibden's and he gave me the feather to put in it.
All you need now is some chicken bones.
I know, dude. That's all
King
I told.
King Diamond.
Yeah, I told Travis. I was like, "Yeah, I need like a bone necklace." And they were eating. They had just made chicken and dumplings. He's like, "Dude, we got some chicken bones in the trash. Yeah, I can do it. I'll make you a necklace."
That's perfect.
There you go.
Watch out for El Guapo, someone says on the picture. That's good,
is
man.
Is this live right now? Or is
would you say that we have a plethora of likes?
Is it a cornucopia of likes? Quite? Yeah. Or just a plethora?
It's just a plethora.
Could it be? Not quite a cornucopia yet.
Could it be that you're just taking your misdirected anger at me?
Where did Matthew go? He's flying drones, huh?
Oh, I can too, man. I love that movie.
Matthew's going to get a drone shot, an overhead view.
We should all go together and watch that movie one night.
I think he's dressed as a Unabomber. Oh, wait, that's a normal guy.
Am I allowed to bring up a...
That just might be an act.
That is not Crocodile Dundee. That's just a random dude in a hat.
My face when you ask somebody what their costume is and they say I'm an active shooter.
Wah, wah, wah.
Sorry.
There's Wilson.
That would be scary, though.
Yeah, it would be scary.
That's
best
pretty
costume.
Clever. Check that out. Castaway.
Yeah, oh, yeah. That's good. Yeah,
right on.
I like that. He had Wilson and everything.
Wilson!
I'm sorry, Wilson.
Oh, man.
Can I turn this up?
Has anybody seen the show What's Last that? Man on Earth?
Yeah, give him a little bit less mic and a little more headset. Can you do that?
Boom.
Is that check? How
that?
How's that, Sam? A little better?
More headset? Let's see. Are you mic three?
Sam and...
Here, let me follow this cord.
How's that?
Whoa, down a little. That was mine, actually.
He's right here. He's four.
Okay. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Perfect. Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yee.
Oh, there's Donkey Kong.
Oh, yeah. Check that out. Is that Donkey Kong or King Kong?
That's Harambe.
I think King Kong.
Nice. Boom, roasted.
All right. Dude, somebody should have came as a zombie Harambe.
That would have been good.
Her zombie.
I should have came as an Eskimo because I'm freezing right now.
Yeah.
No doubt.
I'll be one here in a minute.
Oh, you can't say Eskimos anymore, can you?
Inuit. First peoples.
Inuit.
What?
But Eskimo's
That's
more
offensive?
Fun to say.
Yeah. I don't know if we're allowed to describe what's going on right now.
I'm pulling my costume up.
Matthew Harvey.
I'm afraid my SIM card wasn't formatted correctly.
Oh man.
You brought your drone, Matt?
Yeah.
Did you get some good shots?
No, because the SIM card's not formatted correctly. Yeah.
It's a smart drone.
Yeah, that kind of sucks.
That's
but
crazy, man.
What are you going to do?
The smarter they get, the harder they are to operate.
I know. I figured something like that would happen.
Which one?
Raphael.
I like Raphael the least. I'm a Michelangelo guy.
Well, he's
just
got a
based
attitude.
On that one game, though, really.
No,
right?
I like Michelangelo just because he was funny.
Yeah.
He was the coolest. And nunchucks.
A little too Raph. It's one of my favorite.
Look, that kid's Starbucks.
Lines.
James, I haven't gotten a chance to
tell
you.
That's awesome.
I'm super
wow.
jealous of your cover photo.
That's, is that Caleb Bynes' mom?
Check
that
out. New York City skyline.
That's pretty awesome, isn't it?
You know how many times
that's Caleb Bynes' mom.
The computer and I thought, I'm going to steal
that.
He won't.
Yeah, it is.
Well, I tell you what, I'm going to retire it soon and I'll send it your way.
Beverly?
I'll take it. Game of Thrones or something?
Yeah.
Or Lord of the Rings or something?
Yeah.
Generic fantasy title here.
I like that. There's some Scarborough Festival.
Game of the Rings.
That's it. Yeah.
There you go.
Matthew, could you give me just a tad more headset?
Does this kid
We had a debacle a few minutes there. Yeah. Well, down there.
Looks like this little kid
yeah, we're
got
good.
Blacked out
I'm just
context,
messing with you.
Does it not?
It was perfect.
Yeah.
Dude, this is a good idea, like the booth thing.
Yeah, other than it being think? Pretty cold. There's the Scarborough.
Put your jacket on. It ruined the costume.
He is dedicated to the
costume. Is that a barista?
Yeah, the little Starbucks kid, I think, it belongs to her.
It's a vanilla mocha frappe.
That's cute.
I could drink him all up.
Discount tires over here.
Whatever that
didn't.
Whatever that whiff was.
Dude, I was about to say
oh, my God.
Sam had a funny. Sam had a funny, and I think Matthew just hit his face.
Somebody tore some
that was gonna say,
air
that
was
not,
not
a
nice.
Mocha.
That was not nice, sir.
It did not smell like Starbucks.
And it
Oh, did we get crop dusted?
We did.
Oh, man. So.
That was bad.
Hey, where's Jimbo at? Yeah.
Who would do a drive-by on us?
Oh, man.
And Matthew knocks his head on the mic on the way up.
Oh. Save me one of those.
Please. That was not nice, sir.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
That was like baby food.
That was bad. I had to stand up, that guys. I wanted to see everybody.
Yeah, I can't believe somebody would do a drive-by on us like that, man. That's dirty.
Well, there's Peter Pan.
Yeah, there's Peter.
This guy dressed as a painter.
There's Puff the Magic Dragon.
If you're listening to this show, oh, yeah? You did that.
Man.
If you're listening to the podcast.
Shame on you.
When you hear this next week or whatever on your drive home, send us a message and let us know who that was.
Shame.
Is
that Putin?
Yeah.
Yeah. Somebody did a drive-by on us.
It hit three out of a...
looks like the golf ball game's getting some play over here, too.
A little ladder golf?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just put that together today.
Oh, that was provided by Kickbacks in the 12 o'clock
I brought it and just threw it out there to see what would happen.
Nice. It's a
is
hit.
That what that is?
Mr. Dino is playing it. Looks like hit. He's my neighbor.
Well, there's Patrick Howell, our newest Fannin County Sheriff deputy.
So he's really? He's what? Not just dressed like a...
cop? No, yeah. He actually is one.
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. So
Dracula coming in hot.
Oh, Dracula coming in hot.
Got slick back hair.
He's coming in hot.
There we go. Oh,
that kid is living it,
whoa,
too.
Whoa.
There's Chunga. Jim's back.
Hey, Jim, how are you?
Jimbo lurking in the back.
Look, say hello.
He did came back. Look at that. Look at Dracula here. He ran up on me.
With full teeth and everything.
Happy Halloween from Dracula.
Yeah. He almost got a steak. He ran up on me.
He's a la carte.
Yeah.
Ah.
So,
I like his confidence too.
Yeah.
You got to be confident in your costume, man.
You do.
I don't know who you are.
Here comes Catwoman.
Yeah.
Look at Master Chief walking down the road. Look at that.
Oh, dude,
look at this Master Chief right here.
Oh, yeah.
Right behind Catwoman.
Super cool.
See that, Jim? Master Chief?
Can we go live?
I
want to
be Master
Facebook?
Chief.
Yeah, go live.
Go trade him costume.
Yeah, go live on the Facebook, the Siren page. We're about to go live.
Oh, yeah, dual, we've never gone broadcast. Live
before. We're breaking barriers today.
We've never gone
we're
live.
We're going to go simulcast.
How do you do that?
I'm not sure. I've never gone live. Have y'all ever gone live?
Jim
goes Jimbo. Live. He used to have a TV show on Wednesday nights.
How do you
yeah,
go
he did.
Live? On the? Can you go live here? How do you do that?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
It is a lot of fun.
Sorry. Appreciate it. All right, here we go.
This is chaos.
Square's looking good. I'm glad we can do some stuff like this down here. I know this has been going on for a few years now, but it's pretty cool to see it successful.
I would say this is its biggest turnout.
No doubt.
It must be, yeah.
Did you go last?
The kids don't have to deal with the razor blades and the
syringes and stuff.
Speaking of the side of the mic.
Like we had to worry about.
Side of the mic. Yeah, just turn it.
Guess what?
There
we were
go.
Trying to go live and my phone died. Luckily, I carry a spare.
Luckily, you carry seven phones.
You two phone having.
I know it. Work phone and memes, man. Work phone and memes.
You're like Kevin Gates.
Cornbread eating.
I like cornbread and milk. Let's see here. 12 o'clock siren page. Go live.
Mustard and biscuits.
And we are doing it.
That child over there is barefooted.
Lord have mercy.
I would assume he's
somebody
got cold
here
toes
is
as well.
Dressed as a bad parent. That one hit Sam a little late.
Yeah.
That or his mic's on a delay. I don't know.
Sorry, my sound effects are on a delay, too.
I think Sam's voodoo is kicking in.
No, it just keeps going. It just keeps going. The crowd did not like that.
Are they booing? Someone just threw a tomato at me.
Jeez, what a rough crowd here. What's the line for? Is that for the pumpkin patch?
All right, everybody.
There's like a line of about 30 people.
I did see some kids go by with pumpkins earlier.
Are we live?
We're live, man.
Oh, we're live.
Hello.
What's
Brett.
Up, Facebook?
Look. We're live. Say hello. This is
oh,
the first
hey,
time.
Carol. How are you?
Hey,
Carol. Nothing much. I'm just waiting for people
sticker,
to start getting on
he
here.
He has somewhere to be.
Yeah.
Oh, hey.
Someone just took a photo of us or a video. Possibly.
I've got my son over there.
Dressed as an addict.
You know what I haven't seen? I've been looking out for certain costumes. I'm looking for Flo or Jamie from Progressive.
Oh,
Flo would be good. Yeah. We should have gone
Who's
as
Jamie?
Joe Rogan.
You're not current on the Progressive commercials?
I don't guess
They're
so.
Kind of transitioning the
we need
focus
the internet
from
to be
Flo
that so you could be Jamie.
Jamie.
That's right.
Jamie's the dude.
Wait, how would you dress as, what'd you say, Joe Rogan?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How would you dress as that?
Like Matthew.
Yeah.
Just look like I'd just Matthew. Have to, yeah, shave my head.
Oh, man, here comes a...
Wear a tinfoil hat.
Here comes an elf.
Watch out, Link behind you.
Oh, man.
Link on your six.
Hey. So.
His ears are cool.
Yeah, man.
He's got water suit. You can breathe underwater with that.
He could be an elf next year.
Yeah, there
he is.
We're
going to bob for some apples.
Wow, look how fast he is.
Yeah. Whoa. I'm guessing it's some kind of spell or something. I don't know.
Where's your other son?
There he is, right there. Walking around with no shoes on because we're also dressed as bad parents.
Nice. Not you, Jason.
Oh, man, here comes the werewolf in London. Check that out. That's a pretty good werewolf, man. Look at that. I don't think they get the reference.
Well, he knows what an owl is.
Yeah, well, he's a werewolf. He's just not a werewolf in London. I don't know. Warren Zevon.
I heard that song today.
Did you?
Yeah,
I love that one.
On the Bowen, I listened to the Bowen Jim Halloween special.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, don't be plugging any other radio show.
Yeah.
Hey. Sorry, I think
look at this werewolf, man. It's got a nose ring.
Word. Cool. Looking good, y'all.
I Justin Horton off from the Facebook Live.
Oh, Big Tech.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that's a good one.
Yeah.
That's a good one. Howdy.
That's good.
I dig it.
Yep. That's a good one.
So on Big Tex, with this hand, he's waving. What's he doing the other hand?
I think he's stopping.
Keeping
his balance. Stopping, because it was by the highway, maybe.
Is that cool?
Oh, okay.
I always thought that was
No, but it's like a
weird hand. It's like that.
No, oh, yeah, you're right.
He's doing this one.
Yeah. But maybe he was directing
the
traffic.
The elbows back. It's like he's, directing traffic like
cop. His palm was up. Like he's like.
Are we still live on Facebook?
It's odd pose.
It's
I've always thought that.
Yeah.
A lot of firsts today. We've never been outside before. We've never gone live on Facebook.
I've been outside before.
Yeah.
I'll be honest. I think.
good one, Sam.
Twice this week.
Sam is going straight up line four guy right now with the dingers.
Yeah, I think we're going to be breaking some barriers soon, doing a little YouTube content.
We are. You know? That kid has a mullet.
He does. That's amazing.
He is dressed as a free thinker.
Hey, so who's coming up on y'all's
He's nobody's slave. Yeah.
Listen, hey, who's coming up on y'all's show as a guest?
That's a good question.
Mr. Eddie Suddeth, we talked to him today, we're going to maybe set him
Fast
up for next
Eddie.
Week. Yeah.
Word.
Fantastic.
I'm not sure who else will probably end up having.
We have a lot of ideas. Nobody that we've – everything's penciled in. It's not wrote in pen.
Yeah. Or blood.
Or blood, as
or
they say.
Halloween contract.
As they say.
Ayo.
Yeah. So,
rabbit. How long have we been live?
Well, we're working on an hour
630.
And 17 minutes. It's 6:30. We're getting close to shutting it down.
Yeah, we are winding down.
They're out of candy over there.
We're gonna
at the Kikbax booth.
We're gonna burn up all our anytime minutes.
It looks like Knucklehead's still going strong on the candy.
Jimbo, you want in here?
It looks like
Jim, you want to get back on the air?
Yeah.
Permatter still has some. I can't see who that is,
Jim's
but they still
come back
have something to give out.
There's still some pumpkins over there.
Yeah, they got a few left.
Amber Bates over there with the Grove Hill Farms.
Yep.
Still got some pumpkins.
Yep.
So
is that
you
that guy dressed as a porta potty? I see.
Right, we were talking about that.
Oh.
That is an actual porta potty.
We discussed that at the beginning of the show, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, Jason was telling me about it.
Is that another mushroom? Mushroom head. Marshmallow?
Bucket head?
Not in my time.
Hey, look, that's a person dressed like an awful new metal band.
Man.
Imagine Dragon.
That may be that. I thought it was that Dead Mow guy. Am I wrong?
Dead Mow 5E.
Yeah.
I think.
Did you just say Dead Mouth?
I just left it at Mao.
There's nothing wrong with
Dead Mouth.
Hey, if you're going to spell it retarded, I'm going to say it retarded.
Hey,
you can't say
watch
retarded
your mouth,
on the
right?
radio.
Yeah,
no,
you're
can't.
Not allowed to say that.
I'm
that's
sorry.
Like Eskimo.
I wasn't talking about
that's
anyone.
No longer
that's
allowed.
Worse than Eskimo.
Hey. Oh, thanks. We just
Thank
got a
you.
Shout out. We just got a shout out. Do we have
we got some hunters.
Do we have
the?
Oh.
There
you go. There you go.
Take a decal.
Cool. Welcome. We don't have any candy anymore. We're out of stuff.
Except for those sweet tart ropes.
I guess everybody's
I think
out
I might
of
have
candy.
Accidentally
Nobody gave away my this. Car keys, actually. I handed so much stuff
Your
away.
Jeep's gone.
Yeah, it is.
Actually.
Yeah.
Everybody looked.
Yeah.
You got me.
Good
you got me.
That's what I was going for.
Let's get Mama Harvey on here. Where's she at?
You want to go grab her? I'll
yes,
grab
please.
Good question.
Casey
Can we get Mama
Ren.
Harvey on here?
I'll go grab Mama
Casey
Harvey.
Ren.
Would you do that for me, Sam?
You watch your mouth.
Where is she? She's over here.
Talking to my parents.
Go grab her.
Sam. She's. Would you go get Denise Harvey, please? She's right over here. We want to have her on for a few minutes before we. Thank you, Sam. Thanks for coming by, Sambo.
Thank you very much, Sambo.
Voodoo, Mama Juju.
You just sent him. He's gonna scare my parents.
Yeah, he is.
Probably.
She's right over here.
You're scaring us, lady. Denise Harvey is making her way over here.
She's about 15 foot away.
Coming over from the bounce houses.
Gray-ish.
Green? Green?
Is it green?
I don't know.
Glasses on. I can't see anything.
Yeah.
So. What's up, Jim?
Jimbo.
Have a seat.
Sam can't find her.
Yeah. Man, where's everybody coming
Sam
from?
Is within arm's reach of Denise and can't find her.
Yeah. Mama Harvey is watching the chitlins play on the...
She's pulling baby duty.
Sam really does look like a voodoo daddy or something. Uh-huh. Voodoo
he
Mama
does.
Juju.
He looks like he's from New Orleans.
Catch that, Brett?
Voodoo Mama Daddy Juju?
Voodoo Mama Juju.
Office reference. Matthew hears the Office references way too much.
Yeah.
I feel so sorry for him. Like,
that's okay.
It's all right. I share a lot of Epstein memes.
Seriously, it's on a level. It's been years now. It's on a level now.
Come here, Denise.
Sometimes
have a seat.
I start talking to him, I just like put my head down like it's going to be an Office reference.
Who do we got here?
Everybody, we have Denise Harvey,
big
my mother.
Big round of applause here. Big round of applause. Yeah.
Can you hear that?
I'm sorry, Denise. You may have to hold your mic like this.
Because I'm short.
Well, because James is so tall.
Hello. You can twist that bottom part and it'll
put the mic
it for you
sideways like. Next to your mouth.
How's that?
Hello.
There she is.
My mom's here too. We should do a mom round table.
Yeah, we should. Let's get moms on here.
Real quick, Mom, what's the best costume you've seen so far up here at the?
The kid with the restroom.
No, the porta potty, of course.
The porta potty. Okay,
yeah, everybody loves a good porta potty costume.
Yeah.
That's.
We tend to talk a lot about porta potties on here.
That means a lot coming from Mrs. Harvey. She deals with enough.
Don't we, Jim?
Joke at home, so.
Yes, definitely.
That's a big.
I'm surprised you went for that one.
There was a couple of dinosaurs. They were good.
Okay.
They're always fun.
Blow up dinosaurs.
The Godzilla was really neat.
And then there was another kid in a car, homemade.
Oh, I didn't see that.
That was a good one.
Do you have a favorite
Prince
Halloween?
Was good.
Halloween, a favorite
what? Favorite Halloween story? Favorite Halloween time?
See you, Sam. Thanks for coming
Sam's
by.
Sam's out of here. Take it easy. Again.
Favorite Halloween time moment?
How about
story?
When Dad got dressed up and you were petrified of him?
Which year?
one year he
what
did.
Was he?
One
what
year
did
he did
a
costume. He would do this gelatin and toilet paper thing, where he would take a roll of toilet paper and a ton of gelatin. This like I was third grade or so, and we go to the fall festival at school. One year he covered his eye, like covered one eye completely, and then he goes over the gelatin and the toilet paper. With bloody makeup and stuff and makes it look all pussy and bloody and nasty. And he's 6'4", so the whole thing works out really well.
Brett's going to go get this kid that's dressed as a porta potty.
Oh, yeah, we need to get him on.
Yeah, we're going
we
to give him
this.
Yeah, can you get
and
him?
And everyone in Prosper was
tell him we have something for him, Brett.
Leave.
Yeah. Yeah, he had everybody cornered because they were terrified of him.
Yeah.
He looked like a car wreck. Car wreck was what he was going for.
Yeah, it was scary.
Car wreck.
It was pretty nasty.
His kids hated it.
Yeah. What's your favorite scary movie, Denise?
I don't.
Do you
like
have
scary
one?
Movies.
I don't either.
Don't like them.
I'm a sissy.
I like.
I sleep with lights on.
Thrillers, no horror. Don't like it.
Have you seen the new Joker?
No.
What was the?
Jim is a big advocate of Joker. Oh, here's the kid.
Here's the kid
with the porta potty.
Landon.
Hey.
Incredible.
All right, we've got.
We want to give this to you. Can you hand him that, Matthew? We have a best costume award.
Best costume of the
scoot up
the
a little bit.
Yeah, we're gonna talk to this kid.
Yep, right there, you're good.
This costume is amazing.
That.
Yeah, this is great. What's your name, buddy?
Landon.
Oh.
Hold what you got.
Hold on, Landon.
Hey, Brett, can you get a picture?
The mic.
We have some technical difficulties.
Hey, we just got to get
who do we
wires
have here?
To reach. He's got a
Landon.
Big costume.
Landon?
Landon here is here with the porta potty costume, the best costume that we've seen today. He just won the award, the 12 o'clock sirens, best costume of the night. We'd like to give him a big shout out.
Yeah,
good job,
Landon. We're going to get his picture. We're going to put it on our page. It's fantastic.
Good job, Landon.
Did you make that yourself?
Me and my mom did.
Yeah? Is this your mom here?
Mm-hmm.
Good job, Mom. Good job.
So for those of y'all listening, it is he's wearing those one of the costumes that it looks like you're carrying somebody, but he took a different take on it. He is actually inside of a porta-john, and it looks like he is on the throne with his there are some little toddler jeans, a small pair of boots. They fashion some legs, and he is reading a copy of the Trenton Tribune, if I'm not mistaken.
Wow. Are you guys from Trenton?
Yes, I'm from Trenton Middle School.
Is that accurate? Oh, middle school newspaper? Very
wow.
cool.
Very cool.
And you want to give your school a shout-out?
You want to say hi to any of your friends?
Hi.
Very cool. It looks like he's carrying a porta potty while somebody is inside using it. And by far the most innovative homemade, right?
Yeah, that's
completely
a great.
Completely homemade. How long did it take you guys to make this?
About 3 days.
When did you come up with the idea?
I saw it on a Halloween costume and I really wanted to.
And you thought
it.
I could make that?
Yeah, so
yeah,
my
it looks
dad's
great.
A plumber, so he got the box.
Oh, how perfect. Heavy
is it? Very cool.
Is it heavy?
No. I have pipes going in my shorts to help me support it.
There you go. Very cool. Thanks for coming on. That's a really cool costume.
Who brought you out here today?
My mom and my dad and my brother and sister.
I think this cool. is Mom right here.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Mom. How you doing?
You want to say hello, Mom?
I'm Lena's mama.
proud mom of the porta potty kid.
What to do when your 13-year-old tells you he wants to get out of the house.
He is now the porta potty kid. Yeah. I'm sorry.
It looks fantastic.
Well, Landon, good job. Thank you very much for coming by and creating something so cool.
Congrats on the creativity.
Hey, the Three Amigos costumes are pretty darn good.
Thank
you. You like it?
Yeah, very nice.
They're cold.
It's one of the more popular trios.
Yeah. I like it.
It was this or ZZ Top, I think.
No, yeah. I like that.
Well, this makes sense. Yeah. We're all big fans,
the
I think.
The problem with ZZ Top is that one of us wouldn't get to wear a beard.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm out. I'll be honest.
Can't grow one either.
I'm out if
there's
we're not having beards.
A lot of camo, I've noticed.
There's a lot of camo.
A lot of camo being represented tonight.
I think that's the easy go-to. No.
That may just be a casual dress. Look at the face on the back of this porta potty.
That may be telling of our geography.
That's really
no,
cool.
No, the face on the back of it's horrifying.
Yeah.
And it's kind of falling out.
Now
too.
I don't like it. Give me that reward back. Now I'm scared by that thing.
The face using to hold the porta potty is really scary.
You know, I've had glasses on this whole time, and I didn't notice Denise's face was green.
Yep, she's got it painted up. She's the wicked witch with a green coat.
You're not wicked.
With a green Carhartt jacket.
I'm the good witch.
Look at this little pound puppy right here. And Scooby-Doo.
What kind of shoes are you wearing?
Boots.
Oh, okay.
Look at that.
Witch boots.
Cute. Yeah.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo. Like a good one, Scoob.
I think it's cool that the parents...
Was that good?
That was pretty good. I was going to try to...
Look how they did the back.
Yeah.
The back of the porta potty.
Yeah, it looks great.
Really cool.
Yep. Phillip Grintz agrees. Yeah. Best costume.
Phillip's back, and he has his vote.
Hey, everyone. Look over there. There
you go. Oh, wow. They're giving those away.
He's got a J&L contractor...
Thanks, Phillip.
...koozie. That might go in the scavenger.
We should give that away.
Put it out. We had 5 scavengers out here. Did you know
Did
that,
they
Mom?
Did they find them?
I don't know. I know James posted them not long
There's
ago.
Casey Glenn ran.
At the beginning of this whole shindig. What's up, Casey Ran? At the beginning of this whole thing. And I think they're still out there. I don't know.
We'll check the Facebook. I know where one is.
Where?
The one that you hit.
Which one?
Over there.
You hit some stuff?
The one in the bushes. I hid one right by the police department's door.
Is it gone?
In the bushes, I assume it's probably gone. It was pretty easy.
Cool.
And then Haley from Knucklehead, she hid one, I think, one or two. She got hit the T-shirt, and then James hit a couple.
Very cool. We got stuff everywhere. We got people going everywhere.
It's like home
tons
coming.
Of folks.
It is.
Tons of folks out
tons.
Here.
Tons.
There's a Texas Longhorn walking around here. The football player, not the actual animal.
Mom, y'all gave away all the candy, right?
It's gone.
How long did it last?
Boy,
it lasted up probably before 5, because 4:45 people started getting candy, and we were giving
people started getting hungry.
A handful, and by the end, we were given one piece, probably till about 15 minutes ago.
Cool.
And that was a lot of candy.
Yeah. Sheryl Stanley stopped by. She said there was probably 400 kids. I think.
Wow.
300 kids, something like that. Probably 500 folks.
Well, they had full baskets on leaving.
Yeah, full baskets?
Oh,
yep.
yeah.
Lots, all the kids.
Yeah, pillowcases. Yep.
Cheryl also had taco seasoning in her little basket.
Really?
Yeah. And that's Skittles. Weird. I was going to trade her for a Butterfinger, but
we
she ran off.
We had Skittles.
You had Skittles? What?
We had Skittles. Where'd you get those from?
I brought them from home.
Oh, brought your own supply.
BYOC.
I did.
It's BYOC around here.
I did.
Jim,
what
you
got?
Jim
pulls
taco seasoning
out of his pants.
Too.
Oh, wow. My Lord. Oh, wrong one.
Never know when you need it.
Wow.
You could get your sister on here.
Do we have mic on Jim? We turned turned it down because it was Sam.
Yeah, Sam was a little loud.
Sam was in, his volume was in 3D.
Yeah.
So we had to turn him down just a hair.
He's with y'all in the truck.
He had a real unique energy about him.
Yeah. I had chili Sunday night.
There's my sweet
Monday
wife.
Monday night, Tuesday night.
Did you walk by us about 15 minutes ago?
No, sir.
Oh, man. Were you that guy?
No, I wasn't.
Did you crop dust us?
I wish I would have been.
Somebody did.
Somebody's going to listen
later.
Somebody
did a drive-by on us.
That was me.
I thought it was. Yeah.
I think it's one of you guys.
Was it running by fruiting?
Somebody cropped dusted us earlier, Mom.
When you play back and listen to this episode, you can actually see you believe me get that? Hit on the mic. You can see it.
Wasn't me.
So what have you been up to? You've been in England?
Yes.
Visiting your sister?
Where'd you go to? You went to a new part of England. You hadn't been there, right?
I'd been there before, but I was probably 20 when I went there. To the Lake District.
Ah, where's
beautiful.
That?
Beautiful. It's up in the northern part of England. Very, very pretty. Lots of lakes, hills.
Cool.
Gorgeous.
What'd you do there?
Kind of like northern Fanning County.
You walked. Bunch, North Fanning.
You just walked?
Walked.
How do you know where to walk to?
My sister took me. You can go anywhere. You leave the roads and go off in the countryside. And
on trails?
You've just venture out?
All over. Yeah, you
that
can
sounds
go
dangerous.
Over farms.
Do they have there's bears and stuff there?
No wild animals.
None?
The wildest animal in the
in
UK.
The
UK.
Fox.
Really?
Like
mole.
A mole.
Badger.
I have a mole.
We don't have bears. Have rabbits.
Hey, do you remember that time when I went on vacation
California.
With y'all and I was lost
yes.
in New Mexico?
Yes, I remember it very well because you had my youngest son with you.
They were mad at us.
And we were near Mexico, Jim.
Yeah, we were in New Mexico.
And we were very afraid that you'd all gone
pre-cell phone,
missing
pre-cell
to Mexico.
Phone, like maybe Bieber was around.
We could have gotten taken by Walter White or
that
something.
That was a good trip.
It was seriously scary because I think we even contacted the cops, didn't we?
And I think that you guys solely blame me
probably.
For that. That's not the case.
There's James. What's up,
probably.
Buddy?
No, that wasn't the case. We were at McDonald's, and there was some girls kind of eyeing us, you know, and we were like, what's up?
How old were you, Brett?
Brett was like
12.
Seven.
Yeah.
I don't know. I was older than that.
I see everybody's getting
Matthew
popcorn.
Matthew always laughs
because
there's a picture of me shoving my finger in a little astronaut.
Universal Studios.
Spaceship.
You guys almost lost Jim.
No, we stayed at a hotel New Mexico, and we went across the street highway or whatever to this little truck stop town.
Yeah.
To get some McDonald's, us three. And then
Joe Dirt.
Two or three girls were there, and they were like loud or something, and we got talking to them or something. They're like, hey, y'all want to
go
ride
off
around?
In a
we're
car
like,
with
yeah.
Them?
Yeah, we
yeah
went
you went off in a car with two strangers.
I remember driving off and doing a U-turn.
And my 12-year-old.
And then that's about,
like,
just kind of hanging.
Wow.
We got back to the hotel. It was like, all right, that was cool.
We must have been gone too long, I guess.
And your old man came and was knocking
yeah,
on the
they
door.
Yeah, they were freaking out.
You went to the bathroom and hid.
Yeah.
And Brett acted like he was asleep.
Yeah.
And I had nowhere to go.
Yeah.
I took the full brunt.
They're angry.
Greg.
They were angry.
Hey,
up.
Weren't you guys talking about a concert several years ago that a certain 10-year-old went to? And when he came home, he was telling me how
summer
he was
sanitarium?
ripping the seats off the chairs
that was
and throwing
sanitarium,
them.
Yeah.
You went with us?
No, y'all didn't.
No,
y'all
he was
didn't
there.
Invite me.
No, he
I
went with another
own.
Friend.
I went with another friend. Y'all were on field. Y'all had field tickets.
He
it's
sat
the
by himself
sanitarium in the old Cowboy Stadium.
Yeah,
no, we were in the stands.
And it was, they had.
Oh, I thought y'all were on the field. I was dead center in the stands.
Oh, but do you remember all the
yeah,
chairs?
Yeah, I got hit in the face.
Me and
Brett was ripping.
Me and my friend Justin Lantry from Brian Monroe.
Yeah.
We saw everybody doing that, and we just started ripping off seats, chunking them.
It was insane.
It was insane. That was a good show. That was
I,
the last
I remember
time
saying
I have,
to you,
stadium.
Is that allowed? And you said, oh, yeah, everyone
was
doing
it.
Yeah.
Thanks, Matthew.
It was just Cowboys seats. We were there for Metallica. Come on.
Hey, I saw a guy that show get knocked out right beside me, and he fell down the stairs.
and I didn't even move. I just acted like I didn't see anything.
we were trying to knock down the big stacks of tortilla chips from the vendors on the floor.
So
we were about 10 rows up, and we'd get all the seat cushions that landed on us, and we'd try to throw them. They had big stacks of tortilla chips.
Yeah.
So we were just trying to hit the tortilla chip boxes.
I remember when all these fans started standing up in the stands and ripping these Cowboys, like, they had the little cushions in there.
Yeah.
They started ripping them up and chunking them. And, like, we're looking around, and we see people, like, you remember at the old stadium it was open at the top,
and they
had that little suspended, like, score game or score whatever
board thing
out there. And people were, like, swinging them, and they were, like, frisbeeing them to land it on there. And I was like, oh, man, I can do that as, a little kid. And I remember I reached back, boom, slung that thing, and it dove so fast straight down. And this guy had his beer sitting on this little ledge. Bam, it hit his beer and knocked down. And he looked back up and knew it was me and just pointed right back up at me.
What'd you do?
I think I ducked behind a
10.
Yeah,
you were young.
Sixth grade.
10? He was young.
Just a pup.
I
rode my dirt bike to Brian Rowe's house. And then his parents drove us
In
there.
Hindsight.
Especially as I know what the parents did on the way there with them in the car.
Oh, my goodness.
They did? They played Nickelback.
Yeah.
That's what they did.
The worst thing that
they played Nickelback on the way, yeah. How awful.
I'm so mad right now.
Terrible parents.
No, they brought us. They took us to Summer Sanitarium.
How dare they?
That'll tell you.
So, yeah, that was Metallica's Summer Sanitarium.
That was the first time I saw a pregnant woman smoking.
That's great.
Really?
I remember being like, dude, I shouldn't be doing that. Huh. Did I just, like, take the mood down a little bit?
Are you guys as cold as I am?
Yeah. It's a little chilly.
It's pretty
I'm not
pretty,
sure. Pretty See you, Jim. Thanks for coming by again.
Yeah. See you, Jim.
Bye, Jim.
Jim McDonald.
James is back.
Friend of the show. We got
Welcome back, James.
Hi, guys.
Are you Dusty Bottoms?
Yeah,
he's Chevy.
Okay.
You got to be Martin Short, right?
Yeah.
Obviously.
Lucky day.
Obviously.
Farther, farther, farther,
At least
farther,
I have the gunfire.
Let's hear that.
Chip, 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 chip.
Not
At least I have the gunfight scene.
I think my mic's off.
Yeah.
I don't get a cool name.
Hello,
but.
I hear you.
Okay.
You're on.
These guys are always turning my mic off.
I told Mama Harvey, actually I told Matthew that Greg Harvey should show up as the German pilot.
Yeah.
Then I learned about trick photography.
Of the mail plane?
Yeah.
He should be showing up as a
How can you tell it's
American
mail plane?
Airlines pilot.
Didn't you see his little balls?
Yeah.
Any minute.
Any minute,
huh? One of the best parts of that movie.
Yeah, it's good. It's good stuff. Good stuff.
I don't know. I like the... I'm partial to the My Little Buttercup scene.
That is a good one.
Man, there's been too many times that I've sang that song, though, like the word buttercup or something was brought up, and I've sang that song with somebody, and they had no clue what I was doing.
I have no idea what y'all are talking about right now.
Three Amigos.
You have a lovely podcast voice, Denise. Has anyone ever told you that?
Say something.
Hello. Hello.
Hello, governor.
Hello. How are you?
So when did you get back from England?
A week ago.
Cool.
Fancy.
How long were you there?
Sunday. 10 days.
Did you fly?
Yes.
Are your arms tired?
Never heard that before.
Yes. Come on, Matthew.
Business
need
on
a rim
the way
shot
back.
For stuff like that.
Oh, nice. That is fancy.
On a 767.
Goodness.
Scoreboard.
Goodness. Yeah.
Big
scoreboard
big
on that.
The question, though, is did you get first? Did you get business? Did you
I
get
got
paid?
Business.
Got business.
Business.
All right. On the way there.
Wow. Fancy. Yeah.
We're fancy
ways.
Around here.
There and back business.
Both ways?
What'd you have
no,
for,
not both ways.
Did
I got,
did you get stuck in coach
What's
on the way
business
back?
Like?
Premium coach on the way.
What do you get with business class?
Slight first.
Well, explain that because not many people get to
you
go
get
in
a
first
nicer
class
seat.
What's business class? Nicer seat?
A
wider?
A leather
what?
Seat that flattens down to a bed.
Gives you compliments.
You get unlimited alcohol, which I do not really drink that much.
Okay.
But nice meals.
Okay.
Nobody sitting right next to you.
Mm-hmm.
As my wife sits next to you.
Which is very nice.
If I ever drink...
Hi, Ashley.
You know, I mean, I do drink, but if I ever
James
drink too
wife.
Much, it's on an airplane.
Oh, that's the best time, though.
Yeah. Screwdrivers, for some reason. I don't know why.
It's
I like to get time. Really, really drunk on an airplane and then go rent a car. I'm just kidding. Just a disclaimer, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
Wow.
But you got to think about that sometimes.
Yeah.
Before well, you drink and rent a car.
This has been a lot of fun.
Yeah.
We've had a lot of guests. We've seen a lot of cool costumes.
Well, since Mom's sitting there, you want to do five questions with her?
Would you like to do that?
Maybe wrap it up on that?
You got the jar, draw them out.
Yep. Go for it.
Totally random, or you want us to, weed through them?
We're probably wrapping up, aren't
we? Yeah, we're wrapping up.
Got an hour and 40 into it.
Because I'm cold.
Yeah, basically because James is cold.
Yeah.
We're wrapping it up with Denise.
I'm just going to random draw here.
What you got?
What is the name of your Wi-Fi at home?
I know it.
What the code?
And password.
No, like the name of it when you connect to it.
Provider?
What does it say when you connect to it on your phone?
Harvey Home.
Yeah.
It doesn't say like FBI van number 862
no, you
or
don't
something.
Have a cute one.
That would be cool.
Is that correct?
Y'all want to answer that?
No. Not Joe Wi-Fi or something?
Yeah.
I named my iPhone the Titanic, so when you sink it, it says the Titanic is sinking.
Nice.
But it's spelled. But it's spelled differently.
Yeah.
That's cool.
I like it. I like that.
I have a picture of my hand holding my iPhone as my background.
Yes, you do. Let me see that phone.
All right. I got another one here. Ooh, this is a good one coming from Mom. Name three items that you could buy at a store that could most likely make the cashier uncomfortable. Three things to make the cashier as most uncomfortable as possible.
Vibrator.
Ooh.
Oh, what store are you at?
Yeah, where are you shopping?
Jeez, on Wish.com?
on my sponsored Wish ads?
She shops Adam and Eve.
Denise.
A large pack of incontinence pads.
Ooh,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe it's me that would be uncomfortable.
Yeah. I'm uncomfortable. I don't know.
Yeah.
You guys are.
All right, so that's two.
You're making me uncomfortable.
And a third thing?
Like a big tub of butter
like
or something?
Like a Sam's huge pack of laxatives.
All right.
I thought you were going to say like a large Sam's pack of cheese puffs.
Yeah.
We'll go home and get weird.
That would be all like nurse funny things.
All right. That was pretty dark.
Yeah.
All right. Number three.
Another Spider-Man for the count.
If there was an Olympics for everyday activities, what activity would you have a good chance of meddling in?
What are you best at?
Something every day that you were really good at.
Like making coffee, you know?
I think that's what James chose.
Mm, multitasking.
Oh, okay. All right.
Multitasking.
I'm a good multitasker.
There you go. Really good at doing things
cool.
at the same time.
Yeah. You were quicker with your answer than most folks.
Yeah.
All right, question number four. What is this is a good one. What is the furthest north, east, south, and west that you have been according to a flat map? Assuming that
North would
America
be
is in the west and Japan is in the east, correct?
Okay.
Australia down below Japan.
Asia Pac.
So north would be
Sydney.
Norway.
Norway, what city in Norway did you get to?
Trondheim.
Trondheim, okay.
What year?
That's pretty extreme.
1972.
Goodness. I wonder how Trondheim has changed.
I picked strawberries there for 2 months.
Okay, yeah, I was about to say.
Yeah.
Sam just dropped off a pumpkin for us. Thank you, Sam.
Thanks, Sam.
Okay.
Trondheim, Norway is the north. Okay.
Yes.
Is that not as far as Alaska?
Be further, wouldn't it?
I assume, yeah.
No, I can't hear
it
from
okay.
parts of it.
South. What about south?
Be somewhere in either Australia or South America.
New Zealand, right?
Yeah, New Zealand.
New Zealand?
Really?
Yeah.
That's
Auckland.
That's a long way down.
Yeah.
Okay, now the furthest.
Did you go to the Tasmanian Islands?
Did she say how?
Yeah. Didn't go there.
Yeah, furthest east.
Happy Halloween.
East from here.
It's going to be Asia, India.
I think I can answer
Japan?
Your questions better than you.
You've been to Japan?
China.
You've been to Japan?
Yep.
Okay, that's probably it.
That's it.
Yeah?
It's got to be it.
So what would
what
be
city
west?
In Japan?
Actually, not Tokyo, Narita.
Narita.
Have you been to the Far Western Tavern in California?
Huh?
Have you been to the Far Western Tavern in California?
No.
No. Well, that'd probably be your farthest west. Hmm. So
that's where's that? Like Honolulu.
Central
or Hawaii, actually.
No, how about Easter Islands?
Hawaii's going to be further, probably.
Okay. On a map, they usually have it on the west coast, so don't they? No?
Yeah. Well, it's part of America, so I'm going to say that's going
to
be the west.
Been to Guam?
I don't know. We're showing our ignorance here.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll call it Hawaii.
If you're arguing about Easter Islands or Hawaii, I think you've got it
pretty
nailed there.
I've been to both.
Yeah. All right. That's a good question for a well-traveled lady.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. That was number
four. You've been around the place.
I've been everywhere.
Number five. Here we are. last game of pool you played.
Oh.
In Trondheim in 1976.
Probably not pool. What is it you play in England at?
Billiards.
Yeah.
But I never played.
Same thing. It is the same thing.
Snookerboard.
You know, I really wish y'all would stop saying proper words for things.
I have
to start using billiards.
Last time you played netball.
Netball would be in high school.
Y'all know netball.
Rounders.
They just had recent.
Rounders.
I thought you said something else.
Competition. July.
I can't really say that I have ever played a game of pool.
Okay.
Look at this guy. I think he's Daft Punk.
I think he is. When was the last time you were competitive in something? Sport?
There's Master Chief's got lights on his head. That looks cool.
Probably never.
No.
One of Master Chief.
Well, yeah, in high school, but just kind of.
We were just there. Well, having like the chili finals or whatever you call it of netball.
Yeah.
Was that all the questions?
That is question five.
That's it.
I think everything's wrapping up here. I got to see Knucklehead is closing down across from us.
They're, everybody's leaving.
They're tenting down. The pumpkins are going back on the truck. They're going back to the Grove Hill. The bounce houses are slowly deflating as the night comes to an end.
I think we're wrapping this thing up.
We are wrapping
this up. Did you guys get
up.
Some candy and stuff? Anybody get candy?
Yeah.
I'm starving, actually.
I'm starving.
I'm really hungry. There's some summer sausage from Blue Bonnet in the place.
Well, this outstanding.
This was loads of fun. We gave away a lot of stuff.
Lots of fun. We sure did.
Can we retire to the studios?
Yeah, we can retire to the studios. Let's
will you
do that.
Put a little Dallas in my basket?
Thank you very much, Mom, for hanging out. And,
thank you.
Thanks,
Denise.
Thanks, Brett.
Thank you, Brett, for coming. Thank you, Rebecca, for coming, who didn't get on the mic.
Rebecca.
But is standing right behind us. Brought the kids out and had a good time. We appreciate all of the folks that stopped by the booth. And what do you all think?
Put a little Dallas in
great
my
job,
Halloween
guys.
Basket.
Great job.